Hello, everybody. We are here with the last race of the day, upper bracket between Dynam, Headbob, and PsyJ. It's going to be a really good race. Headbob has some PBs recently to get to 303.14, and everyone has sub 310, so we'll see what they can do. It's going to be a really fun race. So with me today is Zimlik. So, hey Zim.
Hey, how's it going?
But yeah, so what do you think? What's your expectations for this race?
I think it's going to be pretty close. I think it'll be very interesting to see how everything kind of shakes out. But with all the times being so close, it should be a pretty good race.
Yeah, I'm confident that someone will bot me from upper and secure it, and then we'll see where the last person, if they can also get, or if they can secure pot one with the time. They'd have to be aspects 3:11:28, which I think all these runners could do. So we'll see what goes on. So hopefully the race should be starting soon.
Yeah, I think they're getting into it.
So yeah, Dynam and Headbob are on Pikachu, and PsyJ is on Eevee. So we got the variety, which is nice. Let's see. And
the runners and are off.
So great screen. We've seen this so many times throughout this tournament.
Yeah, we'll see it plenty more.
Oh, we got a female Pikachu, a male Pikachu, and I cannot, that Eevee is
male? I don't know, the tail's shaking too much.
Yeah, the tail is shaking too much. I cannot tell. I can't tell.
We'll see in the catch scene.
Yes, let's see what they choose. Girl 1, boy 1, okay.
Nice.
No one bringing out girl 3 for the luck today. They didn't want to use it up, I guess.
Oh, it is a girl Eevee.
Girl Eevee, okay.
That's in the tail.
So everyone, no 11 rivals. Oh, we got a question mark rival.
Ooh.
I sometimes name mine 111.
Yes. You start hitting that A button and it just hits a couple extra ones.
We're onto the toughest menu in the game. Eats all your inputs.
Yes. And one of the most important.
Yeah, because we can skip cutscenes, which saves like so many minutes. I think next tournament we should force cutscenes.
Ooh, cutscene percent tournament.
Just add like 20 minutes to the run for no reason.
Make everybody sad in Pokemon Tower.
Oh yeah, I've never seen that cutscene.
I have not either.
I don't even know if I did it in my casual playthrough. I must have. I think I skipped it. Wonder if any runners will use a backup today.
I hope not. It always feels bad starting out a run and having to immediately restart and get that backup.
Yeah. Hopefully
get good mons.
Yeah, good enough mons, hopefully.
Yeah.
Will you take my speed if you get it?
I'm still new enough to the run that I will reset for minus speed. Yeah, I can deal with some things, but the minus speed, I haven't quite had the time to put in to figure out how to work with that.
Yeah, you said you started running like about a month or two ago, right?
About a month ago. I started picking it up right after the signups closed. But yeah, nice. No, I've been. It's been great. It's an amazing game.
It's definitely the best looking Switch game. Which, I mean,
yes,
is a low bar, admittedly a low bar, but okay. Let's see what these CPs are. Okay. 26, so not
27
neutral.
On the Eevee.
Yeah, I don't think you can tell on Eevee on the CP, but because this is a relatively new thing, so I'm saying all this information, but 26 means it's not neutral. 27 on a Pikachu means it's neutral, so.
Oh, interesting.
It could be, yeah. The minor advantages of early game Pikachu, which are you get, you can know kind of your nature, and then you get the level up on the Rattata trainer if you're not checking.
Yes. You can figure out quite early.
Yeah, getting a great on that throw is optimal, because if you get an excellent, that means you were like 0.2 seconds slower or whatever throwing the ball. But it doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things.
The only catch in the run where you don't want an excellent.
Yeah. Okay, let's see if any of these runners check nature here, or if they just go. Pikachu. It is a... Oh, still more. Okay, Dynam's checking.
Checking.
And it is quiet. I know quiet is good. I think. I have no... Oh, I... What was
Psy-J? Maybe it's Rash, I think.
Okay, plus special attack.
Right? I didn't see Headbob's.
I don't think Headbob checked.
Okay. That would explain it.
Rash is plus special attack minus special defense.
Okay.
I think. So this is good. Plus one of the attacks is good.
Yes, it definitely helps in this. Helps in that second half where you're using Glitzy Glow and stuff.
I forget if Quiet is plus attack minus speed or like plus speed something else. I don't remember. I can tell on the level up, though. But we'll see what... Headbob's is a mystery, so Headbob's just going whatever. If you get glowy... Well, you saw the run aspect did. Aspect had a minus attack Pikachu, and it did not go too well. I was really confused on what the oddish was. But if you could just get, you know, glowing Clefables, 1%, then minus attack is fine.
Oh yeah, it's great.
Just get glowing spawns and XP will fix all your problems.
Yes. XP covers a multitude of faults.
Yes, it does. Especially in the early.
Yes. Okay.
No one's saying no to the Mark guy. That's always a plus. I'm surprised I haven't done that before.
Yeah. Having to take the walk of shame back to Oak.
Or immediate reset, one of the two. Hopefully PsyJ doesn't get paralyzed on this fight.
Yes.
So, yeah. I still don't remember what Quiet is, but if it's plus special attack, Dynam can 3-shot this Eevee. I wonder, has anyone died to Eevee in the tournament on Pika? Because dying to Eevee is faster.
Ooh, Quiet is plus special attack minus speed.
Okay, that's what I thought. Which is doesn't matter, because Pikachu has boosted stats and it'll outspeed like everything. Except Arch's gold bat. So that doesn't matter. Can Dino do 10? No, close. Oh, I didn't. What is Headbob's HP? 13? I think Headbob's plus defense.
Okay.
Headbob should be plus defense. Because if you're plus defense, you take 4 damage from the Eevee. And I think that's what Headbob took. So I think I saw 13, so that was 4 and 4. Seeing plus defense sucks just because it's more chance to be minus special attack or minus attack.
Yeah.
But for Pikachu, as far as minus special attack, it doesn't really matter. Especially with the Rhyhorn strats. You could just do Rhyhorn strats and then you're not really using Thunderbolt.
Yeah, it seems like with the Pika run, you rely a little bit on Pika's stats and stuff, but you use so many different other Pokemon that can either be both good or bad.
Yeah.
Or RNG, but you can recover.
Let's see officially what this Headbob or Tatted or Headbob PDQ is. Does Dynam get a plus special attack AV? Nope. Oh, minus attack. Minus attack for Headbob. I think it's minus attack plus defense. But so that's not a great start. But like I said, just needs glowing Clefable and minus attack is fine. It doesn't matter.
That'd be great. Get that or a nice Chansey spawn. Something with a lot of XP.
Yeah, just needs glowing Chansey or glowing, or even just regular Clefairy that's supersized.
Oh yeah. Like,
just get supersized Pokemon and that's fine. So unfortunately, Dynam did not get a special attack AV. If you're plus special attack and get a special attack AV on 6, you can one shot this Caterpie. It's a 1 in 16th range aspect hit it in the race, in the round 2 race that they did. We didn't even know it was a range until, at least I didn't know it until that race.
Interesting.
Close race so far.
Yes, very close. Although the runner, the Pidgey on Eevee will decide where PsyJ ends up.
Oh, there's a early Pikachu. Right. That's a nice one. Headbob thinking it's AOP and running into a Pikachu there. Level 4, okay. I bury Pikachus if it's one controller because they stink.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no, for sure.
I will call out people burying bugs.
Oh, I've had a bunch of bugs here buried on Excellent Throws break out on me. It feels real bad.
It's without bury, one controller is 71%. That's worst odds, so it's more like 73 average.
Yeah.
And then with Barry, it's like 80 something. So yeah, that feels bad. Breakout.
Yeah, it does feel great.
Anything 80% or higher, like, feels bad. It's like, please, game, give it to me. Like, just cooperate.
Yes.
Okay, let's see what this Pidgey does.
Okay.
Have you gotten screwed by this Pidgey before?
I have. You get those. Well, 3 or 4 or 5 turn fights where Pidgey just keeps sand attacking. It's real dicey when your HP starts getting low too because of the tackles.
Just tackle.
Oh,
no.
Double tackle. Nice. Nice.
There you go. Oh, Headbob is deciding to catch this Oddish because he ran into it, which is fair. Only a great, a little too early.
Oof.
Oh, glowing. Wait. What Headbob should do is catch a Caterpie, deposit it, and then catch a glowing Metapod.
There you go.
Actually shouldn't, but...
Yeah.
Would help
extra
some.
XP. All the XP.
Nice glowing Pikachu.
And Kakuna.
Oh, going for the Kakuna.
Nice.
Okay.
Ooh, and Bulbasaur on PsyJ.
Oh, Bulbasaur is on PsyJ Street? Nice.
Yeah.
Can skip Bellsprout. If he wants to. Can you catch a Bellsprout where it evolves in one level later? I guess you can, right? On 21, can you?
Maybe.
I don't remember.
I'm not sure.
Oh, didn't deposit the Pikachu. Fair. Yeah, okay, so Headbob is definitely minus attack plus defense. That's something.
Yeah.
Plus attack is like the second worst plus nature on Pikachu. Plus speed doesn't matter. And plus defense also doesn't really matter. Like, if you want a plus defense, you'd rather special. seconds of Slug Bomb if you're doing...
Ooh, Bulbasaur trolling.
Yep. I wonder if PsyJ will keep it. See, Headbob be really safe. Really wants the XP because of this minus attack. Don't blame him. Oh, okay. Dynam is going for the level 9 Oddish. 20%, I'm pretty sure. Didn't get the 20%. Feels bad. Got it there, and it's glowing. Nice. Can catch the rat, too. I don't know what Dynam usually does here. But you can catch a rat, too. Should be able to get the Oddish instead. And then that guarantees the Brock's Oddish range. Okay, still catching a Weedle, so we'll just deposit the Weedle. Which, this is fine, actually, because Headbob caught the Oddish, so he'll have to menu to put Oddish in the first slot, so, like, he can just deposit the Weedle there, too.
Yeah, not too much time lost with that.
Diamond PsyJ have nice natures, though.
PsyJ getting the crucial level 10.
No 13, I'm lucky.
Yeah. So what exactly do you have to catch to hit 13? Is it just everything glowing?
I think so.
Including Bulba? Or
no. I think one supersized like Bellsprout would do it. Two or something, like a supersized Pokemon. But I think you definitely need like either all glowing or like a supersized minimum to have a chance at hitting 13.
Gotcha, that makes sense.
All excellence. A glowing Pikachu also. Like, a glowing Lord Pikachu would be good XP. Nice dodge from Headbob. PsyJ already has 9 Pokemon. Wait. Never mind. PsyJ's 9 includes Porygon, Lapras, and Magikarp, so it's actually Did PsyJ catch a Bellsprout? I don't think so. So I think PsyJ only has... Wait, PsyJ has a Caterpie. I don't know... Okay, mark the Caterpie. Oh wait, no, PsyJ didn't have a Caterpie, apparently. Okay, Dynam is going for the rat to get the level 10 on the audio. Did Headbob deposit stuff?
We'll see.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Wait, still has the Weedle. Didn't he catch a Kakuna?
Yeah, he did catch a Kakuna.
I don't know why the Weedle's still in the party, but... Because Oddish is in slot 1, so I don't know if Headbob just, like, muscle memoried or what, but... Yeah.
Well, as long as it doesn't level up, it should be okay. Because he'll deposit after getting,
Well, unless, you know, both Sandshrew and, Mankey appear.
Yeah.
Then it would probably evolve. What level is this Oddish? 10, okay, so this will one-shot the Onix. Just don't get Headbutt flinched, which is what happened.
Ooh!
Just don't get Headbutt flinched again. Oh, easy.
Oh, nice.
I've got triple flinch before, and it's like, I'm gonna die now.
I cannot get out of this alive.
I need a 2C, or else I'm dead. And it's like, thank you, game. Appreciate you. Headbutt is 30% to flinch, if I recall.
Sounds about right. So,
the best outcome you want is Rock Throw Miss, because then you also dodge the absorb text of, like, your health is, like, Oddish is...
Oh, yeah, going back up.
Yeah. So, it's nice when the next fight, the Bellsprout growths, because then you stay at the health if you're full.
Yeah. So it looks like PsyJ is trying to keep the Bulbasaur, and we'll push for the Ivysaur.
which is fair.
Yeah, that's a nice backup.
I like early. I like early evolutions, even though it takes a while. It's kind of nice just to have high early catch counts.
Yeah. Get to avoid that tentacle later.
just catch like Magmar Ditto instead.
Oh yeah. What could go wrong?
Okay, so this headbutt flinched. Tidum also gets headbutt flinched.
And then the rock throw. Okay.
Ripped. Yeah, as you can see, Eevee has a slower Brock fight.
Yes. Has to do the tail whip onto the double kick on Onix.
So it looks like PsyJ's also playing to get Weepin though.
That's fair.
You can see Bellsprouts on Route 25, right? The Meowth route?
Yes, you can see them there.
I guess they're not that much higher level.
No, it's going to cause... You're probably going to have to babysit it for just as long. And it's not lure boosted there.
Okay, let's see what Headbob gets. Rat and Spearow. No, Mankey, no. No bonus pokes. Okay, didn't make that. We'll have up check in the grass. Yes, and a Sandshrew.
Nice.
Okay, will this Weedle evolve?
Oh no.
And what attack cycle is the Sandshrew gonna do? Nope. Okay, usually
it nice. There's no attack.
So you can actually just, no attack. Usually it does its spinny thing or it scratches. Scratches is the better one for, like, the Cycle Excellent lineup.
Mm-hmm.
You can also do it on, like, the spinny, but it's, like, you have, like, frames to get the Excellent or else you get nothing.
Oh, has to cancel the evolve on Weedle.
But, so Sandshrew... two controller Pokeball, and just a great, not even excellent, is guaranteed. So Headbob didn't need to switch to Great Balls there, could just stay Pokeball.
Dynam getting the Mankey.
Nice. No Snek for PsyJ.
No.
Level 10 rat, okay. Dynam 10 Pokemon. Headbob has 8.
Ooh, Headbob hitting the early Zubat before the cutscene.
Just catching it, so no Golbat. Hits the circle at least. Zubat's so annoying.
Yeah. Like, some of these Pokemon are just almost impossible to hit an excellent throw on the way they move.
Yeah, the move one's just like...
It was never intended.
I don't care what I get on this, I just want it to get in the ball. Okay, so Dynam immediately calls or gets rid of the second controller, so instead of having it follow them until it's grass patch. Nothing there though.
Yeah, no deep dive into it.
I usually do you deep dive into that grass patch? I usually don't.
I do not. If I hear one of the cries, I'll go in there. Other than that, I just stay away.
Yeah, same. Okay, getting rid of the level 8 Weedle now. Okay, is using Pikachu for the Sandshrew, so hopefully it doesn't get Poison Sting. Oh, and the Bellsprout. Yeah. I feel like maybe I'm wrong in this, but I feel like most Pikachu runners nowadays keep this Odds in the first slot for this fight and then for the next fight because of the sand true. But Headbob is putting Pika there. Will any of them see the 1% Onix or Clefable or the rare spawn Chansey?
Oh gosh. Looks like we've had a lot of Chanseys in the runs we've had.
Did you catch any?
I had not. I didn't see any. But I think there was one earlier today.
I caught one on Route 6, but I did the Route 6 skip and then I saw it spawn. And then like a dummy, I went back up, hit a trainer, and then caught it.
Oh.
It was not
kind of worth.
These are some spawns for PsyJ.
Yeah.
Okay, glowing Geodude.
There we go.
And lots of bats.
And he does have a Paris in the right corner.
Oh, okay, I didn't see that. Nice. So just needs Clefairy.
Yeah.
You can 2C. Or you can 2 Pokeball this Geodude.
Oh, you can.
Oh! Dynam sees the Clefairy and tries to go back for it and
oh,
hits the
no!
Swimmer. Unlucky. Clefairy, okay. Not a big deal.
Yeah, it should be pretty easy.
I don't, maybe it's 2 turns. Oh, it's the Oddish. Oh, we're gonna see some Metronome.
Oh no.
Oh, it doesn't have Metronome. Never mind. Dang it.
That would be an awful fight to hit if it had Metronome.
I wanted to see some Metronomes. And then decides not to go to for the Clefairy. So, was it worth it?
No, forget
not. Now it's like, screw you, Clefairy. You maybe hit an optional. I am leaving. I'm out.
And Dynam choosing not to go down the stairs?
No, so this is so you can menu. So this is an Oddish fight. So you'll fight this trainer and then go back.
Gotcha.
Usually, I do the second because usually I'm depositing Geodude, Clefairy anyway, so then I'm partying again for like another time, so I just fight this trainer after I go to this room. I wonder if we're gonna see Primate. No, depositing. Primate's never worth. Unless it's in your party for some reason when you catch a glowing Cliff Chansey and then you're like, I guess I will get Primate.
You then do have to click through all of those levels.
Okay, so I think that was double Moonstone for Headbob. I did not see the first Moonstone pickup. Oh! Nice. Oh! Come on, PsyJ! That's a Clefable!
Glowing Clefable!
Do it! It's glowing! Catch this, deposit stuff, do it! This is Headbob. Headbob is so jealous of PsyJ right now. Headbob would love this Clefable.
Dad, I'm getting the glowing Geodude. Oh, and then a glowing Paris pops up in front of him. Not
I think
bad.
It. Oh, it is glowing. Nice. Yeah, deposit stuff, PsyJ, and get the Clefable. Do it.
Go ahead and get your Ivysaur.
Great, great, excellent. Raz is like 68%, 70% for the Clefable. But let's do it. Do it! The Eevee, if this is like huge, huge Clefable, Eevee will be like level 20. Dynam trying to teach Stun Spore to the Oddish.
Oh no. Yeah, you'd be set on levels for the rest of the run.
Okay, let's see what this Pikachu... Sand Attack! Yeah, see, this is why you use Oddish for the fight. Yup.
What are the attack? No!
Okay, there you go, only one. Okay, okay, yes, we're going! We were going for it!
Nice.
We're going for it!
Let's go!
Might want to deposit that Bulbasaur too. That Bulbasaur might be like level 20 by the time. Let's do it, yes! Come on, first try.
Yeah.
Venusaur is gonna be okay. Cool. Oh, you didn't attack. Okay, there's the attack. That okay.
Oh, that was some motion control shenanigans.
Oh no! Okay, that is some motion controller moment. Oh no! Oh, 1% Onix.
Does he go for it? Yes.
Not razzing this time. Okay, come on. Come on, get in.
Nice, excellent. Let's
get
do
in.
It.
Let's do it. Get in. Yeah, let's go.
Nice.
Let's see. Let's... Oh, it's huge. Rip the Bulbasaur. Okay, only two extra levels for the Bulbasaur. Only two extra levels.
Not too bad. Not too bad.
Okay, overthrew. So Bulbasaur wouldn't get as many levels. Good strat. Didn't get the first ball bonus.
There you go. The big green check.
Yeah, let's go. So all of our runners have hit 15, so on levels they're all good.
Yeah.
For Misty. We got 2 1%. So we just need the chancy for all like the rare spawns here.
Yeah. Well, then the Bulba for PsyJ as well. Rare mons everywhere.
No Route 3 Charmander.
Oh yeah, true.
Maybe the Route 4 Charmander will be here. So maybe PsyJ can one-shot the Goldeen. PsyJ's 18 plus special attack, right? PsyJ should one-shot the Goldeen.
Yeah, that should be a one-shot.
Oh, nice flinch for Headbob. Yeah, there's only two extra levels for the Bulbasaur, so it wasn't that bad.
Nah.
And the Bellsprout levels, you know, we're evolving it, so they're not wasted.
Ooh, the sleep.
Oh, rip.
And confusion.
Oh, it's fine.
Okay. That fight was turning dangerous.
Okay, so let's see if Headbob loses any turns here because of minus not this fight, but the next fight. He is 15, but minus attack.
So does this fight go pretty much the same way for Pikachu as it does for Eevee?
So you don't have to worry about getting paralyzed or confused or whatever. Because it like never... Well, the Magma you kill in one shot fight. You can't get paralyzed by the Voltorb because Pikachu is electric type.
Yeah.
So you just can't get parried, so...
Oh, nice.
It's usually a three-turn fight. I don't know what Eevee is. Another... Okay. Oh, this is a... Sorry, go on.
Oh, yeah, Eevee can sometimes two-turn it, just depending on the attack.
Yeah, it's like always a three-turn. Sometimes a four-turn, if we'll see what Headbob, if Headbob can kill it, let's see it. Oh, that was... Okay, easy.
Nice.
But if you're 14, it'd probably be a four-turn. But Dynam got an Onix, but I think that was Chain, because I think that was the last... Onix was the last thing Dynam had caught. Unlucky hit. I felt like all these runners have hit like multiple optional wilds already. Feels bad. Not they kind of got spawned on top of them, so not really.
Oh yeah, just the surprise attacks.
Yes.
So it looks like if nothing changes, the Dynam should come out with 14, Headbob with 14, and PsyJ with 16 coming out of Moon.
14.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So it's all 14 across the board.
Yeah. Just remember PsyJ has Lapras and Porygon marked, so.
Yes.
Actually, PsyJ has 15 because Ivysaur, but Ivysaur is marked. Not marked as caught yet.
Gotcha, I see that.
Yeah. Oh, Oh, Audie's level 15 stats, because we all need to know those.
Take note.
I feel like Dynam should two-turn this fight. We'll see. Yeah. Oh! Clefable! Oh, Headbob! Let's go!
Oh, nice.
Let's go! It's not glowing, but it doesn't
still
matter.
Work.
Let's go. This will help the Mize attack.
Oh yeah. Oh.
That was a motion control side throw.
Yeah.
And a great. We'll see what happens. So we saw 3 1%, one
nice.
From each runner, and then the Onix, which was chained, so.
Yeah. Down, I'm picking up the PP up.
Nope. Dynam is not looking. Oh, okay. Dynam will look for the maid. Santru did not spawn. Is Jesse James usually two turn for Eevee?
Yeah, it's pretty much two turns. It can be three if your Eevee's really bad. You can end up taking two turns. Can't remember which one of them, but yeah.
But with level 18 Eevee, I think.
Oh yeah, easy. And with level 18, you can choose to take out the Koffing first. Otherwise, you take out the Ekans.
I did not see what Dynam's attack was. I just want to see if Dynam can hit the Koffing range at the end of bridge. 40, did I see 40 attack, 40 special attack for PsyJ? I don't know how good that is.
I'm not sure.
Okay. Headbob 34, 32. 34 special attack, 32 attack.
Nice.
What an attack.
What a mon.
This is a Pikachu. I have no idea what 10, 30. Whatever. Okay, I see what that is. Anyway. I don't think PsyJ got the snack. PsyJ did not get the snack.
No, no snack.
What is Headbob's health at?
39, I think?
Can Headbob live? If Starmie scolds? I'm not sure.
And then PsyJ going into this should be able to one-shot the Goldeen as well.
I don't know what Diamond's attack is. Okay, so Headbob's just two turning.
Ah.
Just taking the safe, because Oddish can just absorb, so. Okay, let's watch PsyJ. Let's watch this Goldeen go down in one hit.
That Clefable boost.
Hey, that Starmie did not die. Oh, let's see this level up again at 17. 34 attack! That's so bad! It's 17, that's so bad. Okay, here's this Goldeen's going down.
Yep.
Yo, let's go!
Easy.
Save the turn there. Headbob going around the light pole there. I know, I think that's slower, but I have no idea why. It's by minimal time. Oh.
Ooh, poison.
Feel bad. Healing in the fight. Oh, and Oddish was also in healing range. Good, fine.
Nice. Let's polish it off, though.
Yep. PsyJ 2C, Misty? Is that the
usual
strat?
You can do it. It's, I'm not sure what the speed difference on it is, but it is, it's a pretty, it's an alternate strat you can use.
Did PsyJ need to with this, like, 19 EV?
I wouldn't have thought so. He should have been able to easy three turn it, but. Either way, picks it up.
Yep. Nice Swift. Oh, didn't get the in game Bellsprout level too. Nice. Did I miss a Dino level? No, I didn't. I want to see what Dynam's stats are. I wonder what these Rhyhorn ranges are going to be for Headbob. It's going to be... Geo's Rhyhorn might be a little sketch.
It'd be pretty tight.
Maybe they won't be ranges, but I don't know, like, the calcs, so... Just have to see. Okay, Dynam doing the safe 2C strat for the Sandshrew, which you should probably do a lot of the time. I wonder if Headbob will risk the... Sand attack again, like you did for the Mountain one.
Yeah, so this is another difference between Pikachu and Eevee, because Eevee can just use all of its power moves to clear Nugget Bridge. Solo, easy.
Yeah, and Sandshrew is really the only thing that Pikachu has trouble with. I guess the coughing, too, but. What did Headbob do? Okay, Headbob's doing one controller. Let's see what happens. Not punished.
Oh, there you go.
Got the poison sting, didn't get 30% poison. Did Dynam get fake out? I don't know.
I did not see. I was too busy watching the Sandshrew. Let's see. 36 attacks.
42, 43 attack and special attack for PsyJ. I have no idea what those numbers mean.
At this point, I'm not sure either. Once we get closer to fights where the ranges are a little tighter, I can... I know those ranges.
Okay, let's see what Dynam stats are. Okay, we got 40, 44. Well, the attack is something. The attack sucks. This attack stinks. So, to guarantee this coughing range, you need 42 attack at 18. Mm-hmm. And Dynam's at 40. If Dynam just does Rhyhorn strats, this Pikachu is like garbage. Special tech doesn't matter. I say garbage, it's good enough.
It'll get him through it.
Yeah. I mean, at least it'll hit the Rhyhorn. It's guaranteed to kill the Rhyhorn. I'm not sure if Headbob will be. Will anyone see a Squirtle? We didn't get Charmander in Route 3 or 4. Maybe we'll get Squirtle.
We still have Rock Turtle Charmander as well. The better Charmander.
Yeah, the way better Charmander.
PsyJ in chat saying his Eevee is cracked.
All because of the Clefable catch.
Oh, yeah.
No fake out from... Squirtle! Squirtle! Dynam! Dynam, oh. Please! Dynam, please! Dynam, please!
He didn't capture it. No!
No! No!
No!
No! Okay, I recognize the Squirtle was so far away.
It was.
I recognize it was smart, but... Come what? On! Come on, Dynam! Where's the catching of the Squirtle?
Took a screenshot and just kept going.
Wait, Headbob one-shot the coughing? What the heck? That was low range. Boo, Dynam, boo! Boo. I want those my diploma runs, damn. Neither of them going for Nox Skip, unlucky. And fun fact, if you can run into that bush, the trainer can't see you. Like if you run up into it and like hugging that bottom wall thing, the last can't see you.
Cool.
See, two controller, great, great, excellent res, 84%. Should have done it. 84 is like basically 100%.
Yeah.
If only it spawned a little closer.
Yeah, that's a long walk. But still, should have done it for the content.
Yeah. Who cares about making sure you stay in the tournament? You just gotta deliver the content.
There's a lower bracket. He'd be fine.
Yeah. No Squirtle for PsyJ.
Just the Psyduck.
No Nox Skips. Feels bad. No ditching Bills. Yeah, so we've seen all starters in the wild. PsyJ got... No, wait, we have not seen Charmander yet.
Let's see. PsyJ got Bulba, Dynam saw Squirtle, so now Headbob just needs to see Rare Char.
Yep. Imagine if Dynam just saw Squirtle right here again. I wonder if Pokemon can spawn in the top left, like the Route 24 grass patch, like when you're here, and you can like barely see it off screen. Oh hey look, it's a Squirtle again on Dynam's screen.
And for some Detective Pikachu, trying to figure out where the person went.
Yeah. Is there like a Detective Pikachu 2 coming out or something?
It is.
Or is it already out? I don't pay attention.
I know it was announced. I haven't seen anything past that.
Damn, Pikachu, your detective skills are top notch. Who could have guessed?
There's a giant hole in the wall. I guess they went there.
But where did they go? Did they go down? I think they went down. Let's just walk
down. That man in the corner is not suspicious at all.
Yup. Okay, will we see an Abra on the jumps? The Jigglypuff. I don't see an Abra.
No Abra.
Okay, no one ditched Bill this run. Congrats.
Nice.
Okay, so this is the last chance to see another Squirtle from PsyJ right here. Not even a spawn.
Nothing. No spawns.
Ran into the wall. I was trying to look for Squirtles and just ran into the wall.
That's one of those clicking things off screen and all of a sudden... Start bonking. Only a Pidgey. For Headbob.
It's still in the cutscene. Just flying into the side of the building. Nice job, Pidgey.
Also, this is a weird cutscene.
Yeah, yeah, we don't. This is a cutscene of something. No idea what his rival's doing, but. Okay, hopefully we get Growlithe for Dynam and Headbob.
Yeah. Let's see, what ledge Pokemon do we get?
Vulpix.
Nice.
Pidgeotto immediately. I don't even know if I saw a Growlithe. That's Psyduck.
Nice.
Pidgey. Going for the Pidgey, okay. So does that mean no Pidgeotto?
Yeah. Well. Yeah, because it's the next Pidgeypon that evolves.
How many lore stems does Dynam have left? Oh, Chansey! Headbob! Do no. it! You're my attack! Do it, Headbob! Do it! Do it! Do it! Do it! You only have Oddish in your party, come on! Yeah!
All right.
Let's go!
Yes! Gets the Clefable and the Chansey. XP Pinatas.
Oh! Okay, well, Dynam has a Growlithe. Lucky. Excellent, okay, let's go. Let's go. Who cares about minus attack Pikachu? Just get Clefable Chansey.
You get all the levels.
Level 21, let's go.
So high, what the heck?
Just remember to teach Thunderbolt. Hey, can just do Gloom Strats if it doesn't get a Growlithe. Oh, Abra for PsyJ.
Nice.
So, what you should do for Abra is just start it and just throw to the left immediately, is what you should do. If you get a pat, I think that might have been a good pattern, but it'll just hit an excellent, or you just hit it and the catch count is, or the catch rate is good enough. Where you just where it should just get in. It's like 70 or higher or something.
Yeah. Headbob going for the reset of the area.
Does Headbob have a Jiggly?
He must. No, he doesn't.
Catch the Jiggly and just do Gloom Strats. Oh, Chansey! Is PsyJ doing it? I don't think PsyJ needs this Chansey. Oh, PsyJ's doing it. Let's go.
Nice.
PsyJ really thought about it.
PsyJ with the double Chansey. Wait, no, it was a Clefable. Never mind.
He was like, do I really want this Chansey?
Why not?
He sat there for like a good 5 seconds. Nice round 6 skip from Dynam.
So many rare spawns in this race. Holy crap.
This Eevee's going to be cracked. First ball, let's go!
Nice.
Let's go, PsyJ!
Here goes all the XP.
Some extra levels there on the Abra. That was like 2 extra levels.
Yeah, only needs one. Hey, and an extra level on Bellsprout too, just for good measure.
Level 23 Eevee. Level 22 Pikachu.
Holy crap.
PsyJ is 19 Pokemon.
Yeah, he is not hurting for anything at this point.
Got Kadabra too.
Yeah.
Did not get Jigglypuff, but whatever.
He doesn't need the Jigglypuff. He got the bigger pink Pokemon.
Did Headbob get a Growlithe?
I don't think so. I think that's why he reset earlier.
Oh! Okay, hits the trainer.
Oof. Isabel!
This is a better one to hit if you're Pikachu, because it's not... Because it's not a grass type, it's fire.
Yeah, I was gonna say. I've only hit it with Eevee, both of them, and neither one of them's a problem. It just wastes time.
Yeah. Okay. Great is fine because Vulpix has high catch rate. It's not like PsyJ needs levels right now.
No. YOLO throw everything.
I think might get a level on each of the Bellsprout. Oh no, okay, no levels. Should just not catch Jiggly or just deposit. Oh, okay, everyone's gonna get an extra level. It's fine though. It's Jiggly's nice. Always just YOLO throw Jiggly because, as you saw, it's about to start going up.
And oh yeah,
a long journey. So even if you don't hit excellent, just freaking go.
Yeah. Well, if you do it fast enough, it is almost a guaranteed excellent.
Oh, wait, Dynam's level 21 too. All these are jacked XP.
Cracked mons.
Oh, okay. That was a little spicy. I've seen spicier ones, but there was a little spice there.
Actually, with 21 Pokemon coming out of this.
PsyJ, 22 Pokemon. Holy crap.
I think
no,
it's 21, 20,
right?
21, yeah. Well, he's also got Wigglytuff highlighted as well.
Yeah, so... Did Jiggly even go into the party?
Might not have. Yeah, that would have gone straight into the box.
We'll see. Could just evolve one of the Nidos.
Yeah.
Too, since it doesn't matter for Eevee. But yeah, I think Headbob got double Moonstone, but I don't think Diamond did.
No.
So. Okay, because they have Thunderbolt, Dynam, and Headbob doing the one controller. Rival 3 strats.
Oh, nice.
SSN the lock. Oh, what is. Oh. That's some low Pikachu X. HP right there. Didn't deposit the Pidgeotto. That it gained like one level, so if anything, so whatever.
Yeah, not too big of a deal.
Hope Headbob got put to sleep.
Ooh.
I didn't realize this Oddish had sleep powder. And then the heal.
No!
I put to sleep again! Headbob getting cringed on right now.
Let's say, out of the PP for Headbutt. Thunderbolt for good measure.
We're fine.
Okay, so PsyJ is evolving the Jiggly now.
Yep. So has 22 Pokemon.
Holy crap.
And SSN. Let's see if we see the tragic Abra at any percent. We do not. if you're running AOP or diploma, you just go right back down. But in this one, you're just okay. PsyJ doing cadaver strats, it looks like. I didn't know that was a thing on AOP.
I have not seen it, so.
So, Kadabra, if you get extra levels on Abra, it's nice if Kadabra evolves at 19 because then it doesn't learn Nightshade. And so you can just go one up for Psybeam instead of two to Psybeam.
Okay.
See if this Growlithe is good enough to get the ranges. Hopefully someone doesn't double input and take down, because that's what I did. Like a scrub. Okay, hit the Gloom range. Okay, cool. Tying on level 22.
PsyJ already level 24.
Oh yeah, see, PsyJ went two down, but could have just gone one up because you only saw three moves there. He was probably expecting four. Okay, camp for Drew. Let's see if the Growlithe hits. Headbob luring for a Growlithe. I really hope it's Growlithe.
Oh no.
Typical Route 6, nothing. Oh, there's Rattata.
And then Headbob. Nothing else.
Rip. Headbob tried so hard. So, if your attack is good, you could plus 4 Headbutt the Gloom and still 2 turn. Alicia, but as we know, Headbob's attack is not good.
No.
So, Headbob cannot do that. Wait, did Headbob lure again? I didn't see if that was the answer or no.
I couldn't tell, it was too quick. He also, unless... Oh, Pika picks up an Aether early, I forgot about that. It's like, he doesn't have any Headbutt PP. But
that doesn't even matter, though.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay. How are the Route 10 spawns?
Oh, didn't YOLO it? Boo. You were gonna hit her. Nice Rattata spawn. Nice double Rattata spawns. Nidorina's...
Oh no, Eradicate.
I'm sorry, Dynam. These are some spawns. The Eradicate's not even glow. Oh, Chansey! Chansey on screen! Route 9 Chansey is on screen!
Another Chansey. Gosh. The rare spawns.
Hey, the Gloom strats are coming, yeah.
Nice.
I don't even know what the Gloom strats are. Yeah, those spawns feel really bad for Dynam. Hey, the Gloom is paralyzed! Will Dynam catch the Nidorina? Nice Raticate! That was glowing! And that's why I was going for Nidorina.
No.
I don't know what Nidorina strat you can do for hideout. Cause this Nidorina, I don't think knows Crunch. So I think Dynam needs a Nidoran now. Misses the excellent, oh no.
Yes, I know Nidorino does not know Poison Jab, which makes that not good.
This is a Nidorina catch of all time.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Okay, well, so we know Route 10. So this is revenge for skipping the Squirtle.
There you go.
Riot. If Dynam just caught the Squirtle, then it'd be better Route 10 luck. So Dynam, next time, catch the Squirtle. PsyJ and Headbob slowly coming up to Route 10. We'll see,
How their luck fares.
It can't be worse than Dynam's, right? Like, it could be just as worse, but it couldn't be worse. Unless we get, like, 4 Fearows on the screen. That's worse.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
Dynam, please. Route 10. Route 10! Oh, Route my 10. God.
Oh, no. Two. Okay.
And a Fear...
No.
Oh, no. Come on, game.
Worst Route 10.
This is so bad. Oh, no, then we had... Do you see it?
Oh, there
you
it
see
is.
It, right?
Yeah, I see it.
I think, okay, I think just waiting... I think Dynam was just waiting for other spawns. That didn't appear. We at least got this. But this Route 10 is so bad.
That's rough.
Okay, PsyJ. PsyJ just YOLO'd. Let's go, PsyJ. Okay, well, oh, we got a Spearow. And the Rattata. Does PsyJ need a Rattata? Yes.
Nice. I thought I'm waiting it out.
Hey, there's a Spearow! Let's go, yeah, dodge. Oh, and a Krabby, okay. Okay. This is bad, but at least stuff eventually spawned. But this is so awful. Okay, so Headbutt got Rattata.
That's really allowing them to catch up.
Yeah, this Route 10 has helped PsyJ and Headbob catch up. PsyJ did not get a good Spearow cycle.
No.
Oh, Nidoran, okay. And okay, Headbob. Nice Route 10, compared to Dynam.
And a glowing Nidoran at that.
Let's see what else. Oh, super potion. I didn't know that was a super potion. I wonder if that was on purpose. Whoa.
Got a Nidoran.
It's gonna not gonna attack, okay. Okay, Dynam has 24 Pokemon.
I mean, honestly, not a bad place to pick up an extra super potion.
If needed, yeah.
If needed.
Let's see, Oh, okay, PsyJ, very nice Route 10.
Nice.
I think Headbob also has pretty good.
Let's see, PsyJ got...
Headbob would like a Spearow, but doesn't need it. Chansey! Third Chansey for Headbob! This glowing! He can't even catch it.
No.
Okay, there's the Spearow for Headbob, and Headbob will go. Unless a Krabby spawns as he's walking down the lower line. So we've seen, 4 Chanseys, right?
Yes.
3 for Headbob, 1 for PsyJ?
Yeah, we have.
Then we've seen Squirtle, Bulbasaur, and also an Onix. 2 cool fables and an Onix.
Yeah.
Okay, rare char time. We're gonna see at least 2, right?
Yes. Well, at least one. Rip, we gotta hit all the starters.
Oh, yeah, Kangaskhan. We're gonna see a Kangaskhan.
PsyJ and Headbob in this fight at the same time.
PsyJ 26 Pokemon. Eevee. HP AV on that level up. The Kadabra has so many extra levels.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay, no Rhyhorn for Dynam at the moment. Oh, and look who it is. It's Rhyhorn. I think I also saw some Cubone spawn.
Yeah, and other odds.
Rhyhorn didn't attack Cycle 1. Interesting. Or Cycle 2. The Great should still be like 70%. 70-something, mid-70%. That is dodging PsyJ this time instead of the opposite. PsyJ nanabing. Hit the circle, but the circle wasn't in enough to count as anything.
Let's see. Headbob heading in.
Let's see. Headbob caught the earlier moon Zubat.
Yeah. He did.
Yeah, okay.
There's a Golem that spawned below the spinner, so that'll be good.
Graveler?
Or Graveler, yeah. Big round rock.
Yeah. At least Dynam has Rhyhorn. Let's see if the other people can get it quickly. Eevee especially wants it.
Yes. Though we also had a run earlier today that didn't get one. So that was interesting. Oh.
Who is that?
It was in...
JTC, I can't remember. Tribal?
Yeah, I think so. It was whoever finished first in that race. I can't remember the name.
JT.
But yeah, JT got it. Or did not get it.
It's nice being able to win without a...
without the early ride.
Crappy's going in. Oh, there's a Graveler. Okay. I thought that was a Rhyhorn for a second. The Graveler did attack, it's gonna attack the area. Ooh, just hit the
nice.
Nice. Oh, three Evos, nice. PsyJ has so many Pokemon.
He's only gonna need, like, the required Mons after this.
Right now, PsyJ doesn't have any of the Pidgey line marked. I'd probably take Pidgey over Machop or Cubone because Pidgey's like one level in there too. Or four, they're four. Or just catch Pidgey 102.
Yeah, that's true. That being said,
Machop?
So that being said, he'll probably just blow through Rock Tunnel, and if he sees a Machop or a Cubone, good. If not, no worries.
Yeah. The Dynam is gonna see that catch. Hit the circle, barely.
Wow.
Hit it.
Just the edge.
That's all we ask for. Has a pretty good catch rate, so.
Yeah.
No charge yet. We're doing Graveler strats on EV, okay. Rhyhorn for either of these runners? Nice Graveler in the way. Okay, so Kanga fight? Yeah.
They're almost synced up perfectly.
It's all funny when they sync up. PsyJ is fine. Missed the excellent on the Machop, still fine. I'm surprised I missed though. Okay, level 27 EV is 55-56.
Nice.
Do those numbers mean anything to you?
At this point, not really. I mean, if he gets another level, he's pretty much set for most of the run. There's only a couple of special attack ranges. Later.
For the Cubone. Headbob still no. Oh, that's a Machop. I thought it was a Cubone. Oh, Headbob, he could have gone. Still no Rhyhorn. Oh, that's Graveler again. I thought it was a Rhyhorn for the second time.
Big Pokemon.
No Rare Charms and no Kangas.
Not yet. There's still time, though.
So Headbob is actually ahead right now on progress until Rhyhorn is faster than walking.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see if PsyJ can get a Rhyhorn. Oh, there's the Rhyhorn.
There it is. Right on.
It's one with the Machop.
Nice.
So we just need Headbob. Is that a Rhyhorn? Yes, that's the Rhyhorn.
Nice.
Yes. Everyone got the Rhyhorn. Nice. Really don't think you need to bury these catches. It's like 80% with double crates or something. Oh no. Okay, everyone's on the right Pokemon, let's go.
Nice. No accidental trainers.
Where is... Okay, so Rhyhorn, double greats excellence, 88%. Like, 88%. You should just take the 88%.
So many giant Pokemon blocking the way. Uses the repel. Nice.
Do you need the lore, PsyJ? I don't think you need the lore. What do you need to catch? Just,
The rare char.
Yeah, the rare char and the Cubone. You don't need the Save the Cubone for Tower Cubone. You have 35 Pokemon. Save the Cubone for Tower Cubone. Okay, so Dynam is exiting tunnel after this fight. I forgot about this fight. Oh, Headbob playing with the Pikachu for a second. Okay, will Dynam get baked out? Yes.
It'll say for Eevee, we bank on the fake out the setup, so.
Pikachu stats, 69 special attack. Nice. That attack is pretty bad. If you have good attack, you could skip the setup on the Sophia fight and just zippy zap, zippy zap. You need like high 60s at 28. Which Headbob definitely doesn't have. And Dynam doesn't have either.
Despite the Chansey, still not enough levels.
You'd have to be like level 35 or 33 or something, I think. Don't headbop at a Geodude.
Ooh, dodging the Machop.
The Eevee's almost dead.
Yeah. You get pretty low with these once you get double edge.
Nice cycle for PsyJ, didn't have to wait. Nice Graveler in the way. Gonna hit it. So many Pokemon. PsyJ really should just repel. Like, PsyJ does not need this Cubone.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just keep the repel up.
Oh, what's his Nidoking stats? Okay, this Nidoking stinks.
Yes.
You want 67 at 27? 62 is fine if we hit 28, but I'm pretty sure Dynam not getting it. Well, when he needs it. They'll get there when, after they need it.
Yes. You need her for the Hypno fight, correct?
No, Rattata Voltorb fight.
Oh, the Rattata Voltorb, yeah.
I mean, it is also nice for the Hypno fight because you have a better chance to one turn. Hypno, but I think the Pikachu attack might be too bad to even consider it. So, like both Pikachu and Hypno need good attack. They both need like good attack to one shot Hypno. Does double edge just kill it in one turn?
Yes. Well, no, you X attack double edge.
Yeah, but like, it one shots after.
Oh yeah. It one shots most things in Rocket HQ.
At the cost of healing like a bajillion times.
Yeah, you burn through super potions like crazy, but you move through that place real quick.
If only you had that ability that stops the damage path. You die on triggering this cutscene so you don't have to walk back.
Yep. But hey, PsyJ picked up that extra super potion, so he should be set.
Yes. That's right. Jesse and James. See him again.
Yeah, the next two fights with them are the scariest. With them, not the scariest fights.
Yeah. Okay, what is this Pikachu at level 20? I'm excited. 54, 57.
Ooh.
Oh, 54 attack. Oh my gosh.
Yes.
That new thing is also not good enough. I think I saw 65 attack. It's better than PsyJ's, but it's not good. Or it's better than Dynam's, but it's not good enough.
And between the three of them, we won't get any metronome shenanigans.
Oh yeah, because double edge.
Yeah.
Dang it. Find that other Clefairy that Dynam hit didn't have metronome. That would have been so fun.
That'd be a really rough trainer to hit early but have metronome.
You see, if like Dynam, you could just go past that lady as long as you're hugging the bottom wall. She won't see you. Just make sure you're running into it.
So say, trainer that, vision in this game is insane.
That trainer has a Rhyhorn that only knows Horn Drill. The game.
Okay.
I mean, fitting, right? Gambler has the 30% Oko move. Gambling.
As long as you are lower level than him. Otherwise you just don't take anything.
It's level based in this game? I don't remember.
Is it not level based in this game?
I have no idea. I don't know how.
Oh.
I know it's different from like the original. No Avra for Dynam. Okay, will Dynam remember? Oh look, Dynam's entering the PC. Who would ever forget doing this? Definitely not me.
Yeah, chat says it is level based.
Okay. Okay, I'm correctly picking Modest. Let's go.
In fact, if you pick the wrong flower at the beginning, you can't X out of it, not lose any of your money, and reset it.
Yeah, that's kind of trash.
I've had to do that a couple times.
Headbob, what are you doing? A little sketch, but it's fine. Okay. No metronomes, boring.
That being said, that was some pretty fancy footwork by Headbob.
Yep. 59 attack at 29 for the Eevee, that's all I saw.
Yeah, he should be. With double edge, he should clear everything pretty easily.
Abra! PsyJ already has an Abra, though.
Yep.
If only we could use Ride Pokemon in the underground areas, like we could use the bike back in Gen 1.
Oh yeah, it'd be so much faster.
Feels bad, yeah, it'd be great. Abra for Headbob! Kadabra strats, let's go! Kadabra strats are totally worth it. Yeah, no Porygons. Hey, let's see what the Zippy Zap Poison Jab does on this hit, though. Oh, that's closer than I thought! Oh, nice!
You got the poison, though.
Oh, hey, the Growlithe! Yo, we can do Arcanine strats! Arcanine Heatwave strats and hide out! Headbob has his choice of hideout strats. Could use Abra?
Abra, could Arcanine?
Yep.
Or Nidoking!
Or Rhyhorn.
Or Rhyhorn.
Disclaimer, Headbob should not do Arcanine or Kadabra strats.
Yeah.
But he could.
He has options.
Headbob also getting natured. I'm assuming PsyJ got natured, but I wasn't paying attention. I honestly don't think anyone would forget nature except for me.
I don't know, you get that adrenaline going, you're catching up on time, and you just blow right past the Pokemon Center.
Well, it's just because, I just forget because the run I started with was Diploma, and the Pikachu side only gets 4 badges, so you don't need Modest. So, I would just never get Modest in those runs, and so when I did other categories, I would just forget.
That's
right. See, look, Dynam gets the 28 level that he needed, right after he doesn't need it.
Yep.
Okay. I think I saw Dynam do a safe 2C fight for this. The Grimer can minimize and poison you and stuff, so fair play. You get minimized, and then just miss and miss and miss and miss and miss and miss. And
it's until you die from a slow poison.
Yeah, from getting sludge poisoned.
Yeah.
So Dynam, Route 10 took forever, but Dynam caught a lot of things, so the catch count is still fine, even though the spawns took forever.
He's about to say, at this point in time, Dynam's got 33, Headbob 37, and PsyJ 35 as well.
I think Headbob has 35, not 37.
Yeah, 35. I saw PsyJ's and read it off backwards. Yeah, 35, and then PsyJ has 35.
Yes. I'm ready for Tower Cubone. Two runners have not caught Cubone, so we can have 2 Tower Cubones that are useful today. I am ready. I think Hideout is one of my least favorite sections of the run. What do you think?
Yeah, I don't like Hideout. I feel like there's a lot going on in Hideout. You have to be thinking on the fly.
There's a lot of different Hideout strats.
So. Yeah. Hideout takes a bit, and then I also don't really like Sylph because of the Archer fight.
I don't think anyone likes Sylph because of the Archer fight.
Those are the two places where it's I hate this place. I hate this place so much.
We just hate Team Rocket.
Yeah, Team Rocket is not great. Yes, I also hate these next 2 Jesse and James fights. They suck.
Yeah. Also, I wish these spinners were Fire Red Leaf Green spinners, because they take forever.
It gives you a nice break. You can just kind of sit and watch yourself spin.
I mean, I guess it does give you a little time to, catch up on your thoughts for the fights and stuff, but...
Yeah, get your strats in order.
They're so slow.
They are. They're very slow.
Jesse and James, Dynam's coming up. What? I don't know what Dynam has in the party right now, so I don't know what strats they're doing. I have no idea.
I haven't seen them change yet. So I have no clue. It'll be a surprise.
I'm assuming. I have no idea. Nidoking Rhyhorn strats.
Okay, Rhyhorn. Okay. That makes sense.
Level 25 Rhyhorn, which is nice. I don't know if it's a range, if it gets rid of the range. I know it at least makes it better, minimum. Nice, killed the Arbok.
Nice.
Krabby's level 26. Colbat is also level 26. Oh, help it. Healing the Nidoking, I assume. Oh, X attack. Never mind.
Oh.
I don't know the strats that well. Oh, didn't hit the Weezing range. Okay. Three turn fight.
I think typically the X attack Drill Horn should kill the Arbok, and then it'd be Helping Hand with the X attack should take out the Weezing.
Well, that was plus four, and that wasn't even.
Oh, that was plus four. Oh, I didn't even see it.
Yeah. Yeah, it was the second X attack. So you need that X attack.
Hmm.
Or at least, yeah.
I guess it depends on the attack of the Rhyhorn, but yeah.
Yeah, three turn, which I'm pretty sure with Dynam Pikachu, that would also have been a three turn fight.
Yeah.
Because Dynam special attack's pretty good. That was an elevator entry by PsyJ. That was weird. The game let him go like the entire freaking door. PsyJ is now ahead of Headbob.
Yeah.
Still pretty close race.
Yeah, this is one of the closer ones I've seen.
Because Headbob and PsyJ are a bit have more Pokemon than Dynam, but Dynam's a little bit further ahead. So
PsyJ going for the standard Glixie Glow.
Didn't kill the Arbok.
Yeah, just barely missing that range. This is one of the parts of the guide that says, do not get unlucky. Go for the bouncy bubble and heal. This fight and the next J&J fight are just like, if you don't knock it out, you have to spend time to heal.
Tumble poison, unlucky. Yeah. Only the EV broke out of the poison because of the friendship.
I think you still need to heal the Rhyhorn because you use him in the next fight.
Level 30.
Damn.
Seems like that was not the best suggestion to use.
Yeah, not great. Not great. Definitely has to go and heal everything back up for the archer.
Only one antidote left. But even, I guess just, you still need the antidotes.
Yeah. I was about to say, I'm not sure.
But you still have the pewter candy or whatever.
Yeah, the pewter candy, and I think by the time he's needed again, he'll have done his shop. For the four restores.
65 attack for Dynam at 30. This is like the worst neutral special attack. Worst neutral attack. It's good. It's fine for the run. It's fine for the run. You just can't like save like minor time.
Yeah, no risky strats.
Yeah. Or no like save one.
Yeah.
It's safe. It's good enough, Pikachu. Oh, the Weezing just didn't kill. PsyJ just didn't kill the Weezing.
Yeah, it can sometimes take two turns. That's another range.
This Eevee's just not good enough, apparently, by like a hair.
Leaving everybody on their last leg.
Getting all these turnarounds. Okay, Dynam getting the 5 Ultra Balls here.
Yeah.
How much Dynam needs to catch 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more things?
Yeah, he's gonna have to probably go for the Coughinger Tentacool to just
Grimer
in it. Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's Grimer. Yeah.
And Grimer, you're totally fine catching Grimer. Grimer's
okay.
Compared to it doesn't move like coughing side to side, so.
Yeah, so let's say, and Eevee, if I can avoid catching coughing and Tentacool, that's a great run. Let Staryu be the last thing I have to catch.
As a Pika runner, you're totally like, yeah, I'll catch the Grimer, it's fine. As long as I'm not catching Tenta.
Tenta's so bad.
I would rather catch Magmar than Tenta. Maybe that's not true, but.
Say Magmar jumps so much.
If you watched my first race, I had the best Tenta because I Silverrazzed it and then got an excellent. It didn't move at all. And I was just like, okay, sure.
PsyJ went with bomb strats on Giovanni.
Okay, it is slower, but it is safer, I think.
It is.
I'm picking up the X attack. I was not paying attention to the X attack usage. So I'm just going to assume that he needs it for Dodrio later.
See, will we get the... Well, Dynam doesn't need the Cubone, but will we get the Cubone?
Tower Cubone hike.
Nice, getting good rotation. PsyJ's not going to need to catch as much, so he's going to go ahead and forego those 5 ultras. Nice. Gets the Ghastly. Then I'm going to go ahead and lock him down with the Nenab. And gets the great throw. Yeah, I'm not sure about Headbob's use of Machop on the as the partner Pokemon. I have not too familiar with the Pikachu run, but it did help clean up. See if PsyJ can get the Cubone. It would be a good, an extra poke. Not that PsyJ needs him at this point, but yeah.
We want to see Cubones.
Yes, we definitely want to see Cubones for PsyJ.
Oh, Ghastly.
Nice.
Dan Abbey, okay.
I respect it.
That's fair, yeah.
Ghastly sucks.
Ghastly can totally troll.
Nothing like getting to the trying to catch your Ponyta after you've thrown all your great balls at Ghastly's.
Okay, so let's see. Okay, so this transcript right here, that spinner never looks down, so it's better to go down and then hug the bottom wall, because if you're hugging that wall, she won't see you, so you can just hug the wall and then go under her, and then you're safe there, so then you can see which way she turns, or you can just go or whatever. Yeah, if you go up, that way is like kind of safe. You just have to be aware because she can see you from like, because she does turn up, and she actually has more vision than like other trainers that are blind. So if you're going up, you just have to be aware that she can look up, and you have to be a little more careful. Either way is fine, but the other one just gotta be careful about.
Gotcha. Yeah, I know she's one of those that.
Go on.
Looks like Dynam's a little bit frozen. Yeah, I know she's one of those ones that you can't see if you're hugging the wall. We'll see another one at the Victory Road and then the one at the gate for, I can't remember the route name, the one that used to be Bike Road.
Yes. I don't know the name. Yes, I don't know.
2010 stuff, but yeah.
I don't know what's going on with Dynam right now, but...
Yeah.
Figure it out. Did Dynam catch a Ghastly?
Dynam did catch a Ghastly, yes.
Okay.
Dynam is playing slots in chat, so...
Oh, I thought Headbob hit that tree.
Yeah, holy crap.
Headbob also going from the top. Have you ever gotten double heel pad?
I have. I haven't figured out what causes that, but I have.
I haven't gotten it recently, which was a surprise because there was one time where I was consistently getting double heel pad. You don't want double heel pad, by the way. No. If you're familiar, so you like heel and then you step again, you heel again for whatever reason. So you're wasting like 2 or 3 seconds healing the second time, but yeah, you could do that. It's like approaching it from a certain angle or something. But I'm not exactly sure what angle.
Yeah, not gonna lie, I thought it was because I was spamming like an input button, and I thought I was interacting with it, so I just stopped spamming anything around that time. But yeah.
Okay, classic, no tower key bones when you actually need them.
Yep.
Haunter!
We do get the Haunter.
Haunter is so big in this game, for some reason.
Giant!
Like, look at this Haunter that Headbob's fighting. Nowhere near as big as the wild Haunters we see.
Yeah. It is huge. AJ fight. What you don't want in this fight is for them to double target Eevee. That's where things start getting dicey.
Nice, no double target.
Yes, nice.
And gets the Arbok this time.
Nice. That's
Yo, double target the Rhyhorn.
No, 1 HP on the Arbok.
Oh, I thought I killed it. Oh.
1 HP, holy crap.
It just keeps living.
The unkillable Arbok.
Rip. His EV was not good enough.
No. Nice. Avoids the damage from Weezing.
Yeah, so the Dynam's still going. They are recording, but right now we're trying to get the stream back. Hopefully it'll be back soon.
Yeah.
No idea. I'm assuming it was just like a standard 3-turn fight with Pikachu and Growlithe. And Growlithe being sacked, and then, yes, I'm assuming Dynam is on route, on Pokemon Road, catching stuff. But we won't know if Dynam could just come in and just say that they found a shiny Snorlax, and we would have no idea if they were telling the truth. Just be like, oh my gosh, shiny Snorlax that I ran from.
They can upload the video.
Oh yeah, we can see the local recording.
They'll have proof.
The Growlithe is still alive!
No.
It's fine.
Just a little bit of time waste.
You've helping hand. Oh, this one doesn't have helping hand. Just flamethrower. Okay. Do you have a plus? Can you plus four this? Okay, can.
Okay.
Well. Nice. I don't know the Pika special stats. That was a range of some sort, I think. Yeah, tech is on it. We will get Dynam stream back as soon as possible. Shiny Snorlax?
PsyJ also making sure not to dodge Brock.
Have you ever done that?
I have, and I was like, I didn't realize that you could get past him, and I had to immediately turn back around.
Well, at least you where were you when you realized?
Oh, I think I was at the fountain. I was like, I was looking at the notes, and I turned back around and was like, oh, I just ran right past him.
Yeah, I did you not get like... too far. Yeah, that's good. You have to dismount. Wait, that Growl is still alive. That's kind of... You want the Growl to die so it doesn't gain XP from all the catches on 17. But Headbob is alive, so... Interesting.
Yeah, no shiny Snorlax.
Okay, so PsyJ apparently likes coughing better than Pidgeotto or Pidgey, because PsyJ has coughing mark, but not Pidgey or Pidgeotto.
Interesting.
I will totally take Pidgeotto.
Oh, yeah.
Over coughing. I will take Pidgey over coughing. You can just take it out when it gets to... Maybe he'll still go for it if it spawns. We'll see.
I'd imagine so, because the three pokes is just really nice.
Doesn't need three, though, because it'd be off. Oh, there's a Dodo at least. No Rapidash yet. XP doesn't really matter at this point. Like, you want a little, but it's not, like, super important. Oh, it did break out, so you did want it better. That should still not... That's still... It's still something that really shouldn't break.
Yeah, no. The main thing is making sure you have enough Ultra Balls left for the things you want to catch afterwards.
Are we even going to see Star UCP? Dynam might have a star by the time we... Oh, Pidgeotto, not going back for it. Is going back for it. Okay, is going back for it. So coughing is no good. Double... Okay, didn't double ultra. No silver razzles. Okay, going for the mana. Now is double ultra. That should get it. That's like, I think,
yeah. Being said, he's getting low on Ultra Balls.
Well, all he needs two more catches.
Yeah.
Or three more catches? Three more catches. Only need three more catches.
That's true. I don't know. I've been trolled enough by Star Use that when the Ultra Balls start getting low, I start getting nervous.
So it's Ponyta, Star U, and then either Psyduck or Koffing. Did Headbob catch? Headbob caught a Psyduck, so needs a.
And Dynam's back.
Okay. Oh, Dynam is back. Okay.
Yep. Looks like he's heading off Route 18.
Okay, Pony for PsyJ. Nice.
Nice. Looks like Dynam did pick up the. Pony, Doduo, Psyduck, and...
Just needs two more catches. It.
Yeah.
Yeah, just needs Grimer, and...
Staryu. Oh.
Haunter Z-Bowing. Dynam is back. So we will see.
We will get to see the starter.
Hopefully, they're good stars. The last stars I've seen have been awful.
Shoutouts to Jordan for getting his stream back up.
Yep. Jordan, you're awesome. PsyJ is Candy and the Pony. And we'll probably deposit stuff. Does Headbob still need okay, Headbob got the pony.
There we go.
So that's also everything Headbob needs. Nice. PsyJ, well, if PsyJ sees this side up, PsyJ can catch that. Otherwise, PsyJ is also done. You can remove. You can remove Pidgeotto. Why didn't you remove Pidgeotto?
I mean, he will get a Pidgeot after this. From the Evo.
But then just not evolve coughing, I guess?
Yeah, just catch the coughing. Deposit it.
Or just catch a Magmar.
Yeah, there you go. Magmar strats.
So the left path, the left, the ups. Oh, what's the CP? 1083. Okay.
Nice.
Decent. Nice motion control throw right there. Nice motion controls. Still got in.
Headbob does pull back into the lead after that.
Yes. But does they have the same poke counts, actually? 42?
Yeah.
So yeah, Headbob pull back. Oh, 1% Starmie! You don't catch these because its move pool is garbage.
Oh, yeah.
That's 1%. But yeah, it doesn't have Psychic. It has, like, crappy moves.
Doesn't have Hydro Pump.
Oh yeah, you can't teach it Hydro Pump.
No, it's awful. That being said, I had a really crappy Staryu in my run the other day and hit a Starmie, and man, did the Starmie just... Staryu, yeah, seemed just so much better than that Staryu.
Okay, let's see what it is. Oh, okay! The speed is not good enough. It'll outspeed one of them, but not the other. But the special attack's good.
So. Yeah. Solid star.
Oh, 46? Okay, so we'll outspeed now because doing the 3 plus. I always forget 3 plus 1 is a thing because that was like just starting to be a thing. And then I stopped running this game. And yeah. Okay, headbutt. 1% Vile Plume! 1% Vileplume.
Wow.
There's a star. Okay, we got the star for Headbob. This star is, fine. 1060, a little above average. And there's a star for PsyJ. Let's see what this one is. 1078, okay. That's fine too.
Ooh, Headbob's busting out. And I think that was... He's got... Start here with the one Ultra Ball.
Double great Silver Raz Grimer is fine.
Yeah. With
coughing. Although, coughing moves, but...
Coughing does move.
Whatever. So we're done with catches. I don't know if this pony's gonna evolve, by the way.
Yeah.
I A nice Magmar. Sorry, I'm not even doing Magmar strats. Boo! Boo! Okay, there's a coughing. It's the last catch.
Wait, was the Magmar shiny?
No.
Oh, the photo somebody said. Okay. I just saw in chat somebody say it was shiny. I was like,
Hey, the coughing didn't move. Nice.
Nice. That's a good coughing. Oh, Dynam's rat was shiny.
I did not see it.
I did not either. I did see him take a picture, but I didn't see what he was taking a picture of.
Headbobs, very good star.
Nice.
I think. The special... 91 special at 45? 45. Yeah, okay, that's nice.
That's really good, yeah. What's the speed? Speed's 93?
Yeah, it'll outspeed.
Yeah.
So, hopefully PsyJ star is just as good as these two. Had comparable CP numbers. I cannot guess pace times for the life of me, so I have no idea what pace these people are on.
Oh yeah.
Oh, hits the Raticate's tail barely. I'm surprised.
Oh, wow.
PsyJ. I did not think PsyJ hit that at all. That was interesting.
Yeah, the hitboxes are a little strange sometimes.
PsyJ, please remember to evolve the...
Headbob going back in for the grammar.
Okay, please know you don't need both Weezing and... Well, you do need both. I'm dumb. For some reason, I thought... Oh, I'm dumb. Never mind. I thought PsyJ caught a Pidgey for some reason, but it was obviously a Pidgeotto.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he does need both of those.
Yeah. Wait, what was this star? I was not paying attention.
Let's see.
Oh! Oh no! Oh no!
Very, very fast.
Oh no.
Very bad special attack.
Did I see 100 speed?
Yeah, 100 speed.
What? 100 speed? Are we sure Side Agent didn't do plus speed? Oh, all the CP went to...
All to speed.
Let's see. 111, I did not see what the... Outspeed is 150 something, I think? 152? Agatha's not 129, it's way higher than that. Oh, that's the current speed right now. It's 129.
Dang. That is a fast arm.
I think 152. Okay, luckily didn't get paralyzed. Yeah, already outspeeds Pidgeot. Already run Pidgeot. So I think at this point, unless like Kaden, okay, so we still have Kaden and Archer, but as long as Kaden and Archer don't go awful, which they absolutely could, then Dynam should have it. But if Kaden and Archer are both bad, then Headbob or PsyJ could catch up.
It would have to go real bad.
Yeah. But Katie can definitely go real bad.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, Archie can too, but definitely Katie. Okay. Ditto! 10% ditto on Headbob's screen. You know, Headbob should have just done an AOP run. In, like, all the
wrong race today.
I mean, no one did. No one got Kanga though, so I guess the wrong would have died there. But... okay, not getting the mansion candy. I don't think you need it anymore, but
especially not with these stars.
Well, PsyJ might have could have used it.
Yeah, it'll be close.
Yeah, Headbob has 47, PsyJ and Dynam both have 46 right now. So. PsyJ retook progress lead, but they're about even with the extra poke that Headbob has.
Yeah.
Okay, so as we're getting to like the final stretch because we're done catching, if any of these runners want to stay in the upper bracket, they have to get at least a 308.50. If they want to clinch upper, they need to beat T-Pat's 305.47. If these runners get that, then whoever's in second will clinch the upper three, because there's only one upper race bracket left, which will be tomorrow. But I have no idea if, I think they could all do it right now, but like I said, I have no idea what paces are at all in this game. So we will see. It'll be close.
Yes.
We'll see if they have to do safe strats to, if they can use safe strats to... Oh! Oh no. Confusion's expected.
Yeah.
I forgot. Have you ever been on a run that, like, made to blame, but you're not feeling good about, so you just YOLO the confusion?
I have not done that yet, no.
Yeah, whoever is in third place will, go to lower. They can either be in pot one or pot two. If they want to clinch lower pot one, they need the irons 310.41. But right now, lower pot one, which is not the aspect, 311.28. Which aspect drops? I don't want to play aspect. did Headbob get perfect lane? I wasn't. They're like almost synced.
Yeah, yeah, they're synced up, I think.
With love.
Yeah,
127.
And that's a good star.
Yeah. I wonder what PsyJ's range on the Dragonite's gonna be.
I think he should be okay.
Okay.
But it'll be close.
Teach Thunderbolt here, Dino. Don't be like me and a couple others that don't teach Thunderbolt for some reason. Yo, Thunderbolt tie. Yeah, let's go.
Nice.
123. So, Headbob special attack is the best. But Vu not going for 85% Fire Blast on the Executor. What could go wrong? It's not like Starmie dies...
instantly.
Yeah, it's not like Starmie dies instantly if it misses.
Or it sets up light screen and you're really screwed.
Or that, one of the two. Nothing goes wrong. You just hit fireballs.
Every time.
You already use Hydro Pump, which is less accurate, so...
You don't have to use Hydro Pump. You can X-Attack Scald.
Yo, if you have Dodrio in the party, what you should actually do is, instead of using Starmie for the Surge fight, you should just use Dodrio and just Jump Kick 3 times. Jump Kick just never misses. It's only, like, 95%?
Yeah.
Yeah,
which it'll be great. And if he does miss, it won't be like the super effective electric types will knock you out.
Dodrio surge stress 90%. Let's go. Let's do it. We can make him any percent stress if we really want to. It brings the content.
It does.
It gets your blood pumping.
Gives you the high highs and the low lows.
Yup. Erica, there's nothing fun because Dodrio can lose a turn to getting put to sleep, so just use Starmie.
Here's what I'll say. Once you get these fights, they're kind of just... You're so overleveled, it doesn't matter. Just don't miss inputs.
This is the calm before the storm of Archer.
Yeah.
Hey, it's 10 Jella.
Wiggly woo.
Wait, is Tangela Tangelina Jolie? Or is that Tempta for whatever reason?
I think that's Tangela.
Okay.
That one makes sense. I don't think Tentacool. Yeah, it's Tangela.
For some reason, I thought it was associated with Tenta, but Tangela makes way more sense.
Okay, now off to Archer.
Yeah, the winner of the first race today, J-Towels, came up with Tangelina Jolie. Headbob, it doesn't know where to go for a second. He was gonna go the long way and then realized.
Just toured the city.
Yeah.
You got wanted time.
Wanted to go to the department store to get stones to Evo. Just AOP strats. So, I don't know if you know this, Zimlik, because you're a new runner, but when this category, or like when Let's Go was doing runs, there was a time where they banned two controllers, so you could only do one controllers. And the XC2 Tour fight, as you can imagine, was awful, would have been awful.
Oh yeah, I can imagine. I think I did hear about that, but yeah, that sounds terrible.
I didn't run during those times either, so I've just only heard stories too, but, like, ugh, that sounds so bad.
Well, they were using different mons then too, though, right? Wasn't, like, Kabuto a run at some point in time?
Yeah, there was, like, a Fosse Posse phase at the beginning of this life cycle speedrun.
Gosh.
I'm glad I was not around for those.
Yeah, that sounds brutal. Especially having to, like, hit the catch rates on things.
Yeah, once he catches,
The times would be so long.
Graveler, Rhyhorn were like, don't bring out, like, the fifth ball!
Yeah.
Imagine even going for Chansey's and Clefable's onesie.
Oh yeah, no. That would just be unheard of. Oh man.
Yeah, we get this nice easy two turn fight now. This one's not fun because it's no fire blast, but
can't always be fun. You gotta have some safe strats every so often.
You should definitely Dodrio it up. Or you can Magmar it up too. I think you like X Attack Fire Punch. If you happen to catch Magmar. I know, I think Dynam's all about it, but Dynam didn't want to do it in the race. So. I don't know where Dynam stands on it, actually.
The real range is making sure your Doduo, it's still a Doduo and not a Dodrio in drill packing.
Yes.
That's where the realness comes in.
So when my first round, I used Rapidash because I forgot and was dumb and deposited Dodrio. And then the second round, my Doduo had an evolve. So I had to use Rapidash again.
Oh no, my first round, I just used Doduo. And it hit. It was great. I was going into it. Hey. I'm pretty sure this doesn't always hit, but I'm not sure what else to do, so I think I'll be okay. And I was.
Easy.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll see what Archer decides for Dynam right here. As far as the race goes, I will take like 5 turns or lower.
Yeah.
Maybe even 6, but like that's kind of like the precipice of I don't really want that. But like 4 or 5 I'll take. Have we gotten a 3-turn fight this tournament? I feel like no, but also I haven't watched every race, so.
I haven't either.
The race is Oh, Porygon! PsyJ! Porygon!
Nice!
Oh my gosh.
Nice.
I can't believe it.
This has been the most rare Pokemon.
There's so many rare spots. I can't believe it.
Insane. And a shiny.
Yeah, we saw a shiny. I didn't even see the shiny. But we had a shiny.
Really, the only thing we've missed is Kangas and Char.
Yeah. Once we saw the other stuff, I'm like, we're so gonna not see a Charmander.
Yeah. Okay, so let's see what...
Fun fact, if you see a shiny Porygon, you have to immediately quit the game and uninstall and never run the game again. Shiny Porygon is the most cursed thing you can do to your run. What just happened?
Dynam got turn 2 self-destruct.
Turn 1 Thunderbolt, I assume?
Yeah, turn 1 Thunderbolt, and just turn 2 self-destruct.
So easy 4-turn fight, assuming this doesn't protect. So this is a big if, but if Electrode only does 1 Thunderbolt, I prefer Thunderbolt turn 1 specifically because of this. Because Raticate usually dies turn 2 or turn 3, so it's very easy 4-turn barring the Weezing Protect, which is rare.
Also, Headbob hits the Fire Blast.
Oh, easy. Oh, so when I'm saying that if Dynam gets past Archer and and Kaden and Koga, that he should be able to wrap it up. I totally forgot about Caroline. Caroline could totally also make Dynam lose.
Oh yeah.
I forgot about that. But we'll see. Dynam might have a big enough lead by then. We'll see. Yeah, protect self-destruct turn 1, I find sketchier than T-Bolt, no protect.
Yeah,
as long as... Go on.
Oh, you start getting hit by the sucker punches, and that can go bad real quickly, too.
Yeah, but you know, if you see Sandy's, I think, first round Archer, where it was like 6 Thunderbolts in a row, then obviously Ooh. Thunderbolt turn 1 is awful.
Yeah. Okay, what's Headbob gonna get?
PsyJ can pull ahead right here with, Wait. Headbob can live 2 Thunderbolts, potentially? That didn't
Holy
even do half.
Crap.
Okay. We'll see what happens. Boom. You're healing.
You don't risk the sucker punch.
Oh, the second Thunderbolt. Okay, yep, now.
Yeah, that would've.
This is where we don't like the. This is where we don't like turn one Thunderbolt.
Oh no.
Also, good job healing. Oh, yep! This is why we... Okay, I'm not paying attention to...
PsyJ, self-destruct, protect.
Protect, okay. Hey, the Electro's dead? That's good?
There we go.
Can you sucker punch the Cubone, please, Raticate?
What please, though?
Yes! Oh, okay, so Cubone's focus entry, because sucker punch failed.
Nice.
But that means it can bone ring for this turn. And the Weezing's there too, so it could be what? I think it's 5 or 6 turns?
I haven't been counting. But yeah, I think they're.
You use what, 3 Thunderbolts? So I think it needs 6.
Yeah.
Let's see what PsyJ's Cubone does. Okay, so the Raticate is dead. Okay, so PsyJ has to heal.
Yeah, I was gonna say, he's not gonna survive another Sucker Punch.
So the rich keep getting richer with Dynam having the best archer.
Oh yeah. Ooh.
Probably needs to heal again.
Yeah.
Yeah, this will be 6 turns?
Yeah, this one got dicey real quick.
Please bone ring the Raticate. Thank you. Okay. Well, at least
nice.
PsyJ
okay.
Can just finish it off. Please no Weezing protect for no reason.
Whew.
Okay, they were both bad.
Those were awful. Okay. That gets rid of some of the stressful fights for a bit.
You know, if you do save Geo, then Geo is not stressed at all.
Yeah.
We got Kaden coming up.
Yes.
I'm ready for Dynam to just get no light screen mine. Ooh. Get the Mass Ball. Catch Moltres, use it on the E4.
There you go.
Totally need it. What's the Weezing gonna do? Okay, Grimer? What are the Pokemon catch counts, by the way?
Ah.
It's 47? Oh, it's Headbob is 48 now.
Yeah, PsyJ's just waiting on the Weezing Evo.
Oh, boo, Dynam, you get... So, Zim, do you get Lapras first, or do you get the candy?
I typically get Lapras first.
Ah, oh, boo. Wait, did Dynam not get the candy?
I don't think Dynam got the candy.
I guess Dynam doesn't think... Does Dynam... Okay. Well, I guess that's why Dynam went to get Lapras first. Didn't need the candy.
Dynam Star is too good.
Maybe Dynam had an extra candy, like his candy that's still left, because I don't think Dynam... I don't know what happened. All I know is I'm pretty sure Dynam did not get that candy. Fairly confident. So 50 for Dynam right here. Oh, look, it's a Porygon, rare spawn.
Free.
So did Dynam pick up the Mansion Candy? Dynam picked up Route 6, Hideout, Pokemon Tower.
I don't think he picked up the Mansion Candy either.
Okay, yeah. So Dynam picked up Route 6, Pokemon Tower, Hideout. And then Pokemon Road. So that's 4. And then used 3 on Starmie, and then just never use the fort, because Rapidash evolved eventually.
Yeah. That's what it was. He didn't use it on the Rapidash.
Headbob, 130 at 48. Special attack. Okay, let's see how good Dynam's teleporters are. I always miss at least one. I was so close to getting perfect teleports, and then I choked like the easiest teleporter. Okay, one teleporter. I still don't have these memorized. I have to look at the notes in my.
Oh, I do too. There's a couple times still where my eyes will go cross looking at the notes and I'll hit the wrong teleporter. Have I done the top right one yet? No, I haven't. We should go there.
Okay, so this teleporter, you want to enter from the top because you do that little motion where you turn and look at the screen if you look at turn it from the side. It's not a big deal, but that's the better way. Oh, messed up that one. One of the easier ones. But it's still easy to miss them because it's finicky. This one after the one after Sabrina is hard.
Yes. And for people who don't know what we're talking about, if you hit the teleporters directly on the sides, you don't do this weird animation that loses you time. They have to like line up on the teleporter before they go.
Yeah. Like good teleporters only missed one.
Yeah.
And even though it was like quote unquote an easy one, they're still like hard because the Joy-Cons like. Will sometimes just like not move straight. It'll just like veer off a pixel or two.
Yeah. Joy-Cons are like so finicky with the directions. I feel like they turn too easily.
Yeah.
PsyJ getting the candy, then the Porygon.
Okay, so no standard Sabrina, nice. I got getting like double special defense drops or whatever is spicy.
Yeah.
Oh wait, there was double speed death drops? I didn't see them. But anyway, it's fine. Sweet.
Nice.
Thunderbolt and Slowbro. I had Thunderbolt for Slowbro. Nice. Congrats. PsyJ and Headbob are like so close.
Yeah, they're neck and neck. Will he get the last teleporter?
Let's see. Nope. That is like. One of the hardest ones, so. This menu always gets me too. This menu is like, I just go slow all the time.
Oh, yeah. Well, that menu also has, like, you're doing a lot of planning at that point. You're deciding which strats you're going to go for. I typically just buy everything, but you can. Skip things if you're not going for 2C, or if you're going for 2C Giovanni.
Okay, 49. 133.
Nice. Not bad.
Early? Are you early teeth or late teeth?
I do late teeth.
Okay. I think they're basically the same if anything, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, I don't know, that's just how I learned it.
I was late teeth, and then somewhere along the line I switched to early teeth. And now I'm early teeth.
So I think I've done it a couple runs and it just felt really weird.
Okay, so every time I see talk about this, I get conflicting information. One time people will be like early teeth is like 0.1 frames better, and then next time it'll be like late teeth are 0.1 frame better. It's like, which one is it? Everyone has differing opinions. We need like a video on frame by frame. A video, a like 20 minute video dedicated to like 0.1 second time saving.
Are the teeth bad because you're carrying the teeth longer?
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay, here's Caden.
Caden.
I think if Dynam gets through Caden fine, then they should win the race, even with a bad Carol, even with a bad Caroline. Assuming they do safe strats, which I assume they would. Moonblast, easy. Didn't even get special defense here.
Nice.
Could get Protect, that's fine. I don't know how much. So, to get upper pot one, you have to be etiquette 305-24. And secure upper pot one, you would need to be Ergotase. Sorry if that's mispronounced. 305-03. I don't know how much Dynam cares about pot one, especially because Etchy's in pot two. So, like, is pot one even like a reward? I mean, no matter who it was, really, like, all the upper bracket players are good players. So it's like, really, the pots don't really matter that much. So I'm not sure how much Dynam cares. Not sure how much Dynam cares about pot one.
Things getting a bit dicey for PsyJ on the Sabrina.
Well, let's see PsyJ's special. 118. It's like 129 for Dynam, 130 for Headbob, 118 for PsyJ.
But it's fast.
Yeah, at least it's fast. Can make up time by. Hopefully, you can save like the turn by not needing to X speed for Agatha.
Or X speed for the rival.
Oh yeah, because it is. It does that. Does it outspeed Raichu? I assume
it will.
I don't know. Since I don't play EV, I don't.
I think it's 140. It has to hit.
It has to be faster.
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, at this point, I would hope so. Okay.
Headbob. Is that double protect from Golbat?
Yeah.
Was that double protect from Golbat? I thought it might be, but I'm not sure. PsyJ pumping an extra 145 speed at 50.
Yeah. Oh yeah. It's way faster than the rivals, right? You.
That's 52 for Agatha, right? 52, I think. I think it's 152, right? Tau speed?
I'm not sure. That sounds about right. I don't have it pulled up. It should. I mean, that's a fast Starmie.
Yeah.
Let's see. Caden fight for Headbob.
Easy.
Protect turn one. You're good to go.
Okay, so it'll be a while, but will we see 2C Bruno from Dino again? two races in a row.
Oh.
Because of faint on Hitmonlee and just securing the win. Will we see 2C Bruno again?
Looks like the Agatha speed is 155 plus.
Okay, that's higher than I thought. Maybe Star won't get there then. Okay, Kaden, come on. Cooperate. No minimize. Protect. Okay, easy. Kaden.
Nice. Easy, Kaden.
Don't lost the protect, but whatever. Didn't get minimized and didn't lose the whole run.
Yeah.
I think, I feel like Headbob could do, I know they're close, but I feel like Headbob could do safe stress and still beat PsyJ, barring Caroline really trolling.
Yeah. I think, yeah, there's just enough time between them that if they keep it this rate, he should be able to do safe. Dynam getting the last pause before the rush of the end game.
If only we could skip Giovanni and just go. There was a time where they were trying to. So sometimes when you interact with the right Pokemon, it moves a tad forward. So people were trying to move it into the Victory Road loading zone from the badge check guy and skip that badge check. It never worked, obviously, but maybe it can
work. Is this where the mount skips come in? It's just that little bit of movement forward?
No. Mount skips is just because they're, so Rapidash moves like 27 pixels or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and the trainer's visions are 26 pixels. So if you're in the right cycle, you just beat the trainer's vision by one pixel and just go past it.
Okay.
So that's how that works. It'd be different. The skip they were trying to do would have been different. They were just trying to hit another loading zone because the gym badge checks loading zones are like huge boxes, I think. Like, they go far back.
Just to make sure you don't do that. Yeah.
Yes. I thought trying to, like, so in the water, Pokemon can spawn, right? So I was trying to, like, get far enough behind and then hit, like, a wild Pokemon's wild, like, spawn to battle it or to catch it. Like, as I got into the water, but it would just default to the gym badge check. So, is this 1C? It's 1C!
Alright.
Just hit. Easy.
There you go. You hit a Hydro Pump, there is no need for a second controller.
I don't know if the runners are aware of where each other are. Because right now I wonder if PsyJ will risk Geo. Or if they just want to try to secure lower pot one. Or if they want to try and catch Headbob and do 1C Geo. They're just a little tad behind.
Yeah, so Dynam's definitely going to go for the 2C. Let's see.
Nope. See, we'll see if Headbob decides to 1C. I'm fairly confident PsyJ can't even try to make up time by 1C Naomi because the Kanga's so bad. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't think he'll hit the ranges on the Kanga.
Okay, best fight, because Rapidash died.
Nice.
Best safe fight. Yeah, welcome everyone. So right now, Dynam is winning. Headbob is in second, and PsyJ is in third. Headbob and PsyJ are pretty close. It looks close, but I think Dynam, as long as Caroline doesn't go hugely wrong, and I think Dynam's got this. With safe strats.
If Caroline goes back for Headbob, PsyJ could catch up.
So let's see what this Nidoking could help PsyJ.
Yeah.
Nope, easy. But yeah, so we've seen Headbob has seen three chances, caught one. PsyJ has seen a chancey, caught it. Dynam saw a Squirtle, didn't catch it because Dynam doesn't like fun. What else has happened?
We saw a shiny rat.
Shiny rat.
We saw two Clefables that got caught
by PsyJ and Headbob.
Yeah.
Headbob had minus attack Pikachu, but because of Moon Chansey, right? Moon Chansey? Or was it Route 6 Chansey?
It was Route 6 Chansey, Moon and, Clefable.
Yeah, so thanks to Moon Clefable and Route 6 Chansey, minus attack didn't matter at all.
Yeah. PsyJ saw Porygon.
Yeah, PsyJ saw Porygon. PsyJ also got Bulba. No Charmander. We didn't see a Charmander. We saw the other two rare spawns.
No Char, no Kanga, but pretty much everything else. Oh, we saw the 1% Starmie as well.
Oh, yeah. And so Dynam saw 1% Starmie. Headbob saw 1% Bioplume.
Yeah.
Yeah. So seen a lot of rare spawns today.
Yeah. This has been the run for rare spawns.
Okay, 2C, Geo. Let's see if PsyJ decides to... Yep, PsyJ is 2C'ing, so losing some time on Samuel. Might just want to secure lower pot one, I'm not sure. But Caroline could, I think, still help PsyJ get a hit if it's bad for Headbob. But maybe not. We will see. PsyJ Star has bad special attack, very good speed. I'm not sure though if it can outspeed Agatha. I might not. Definitely outspeeds the Raichu though.
Oh yeah.
And then the other two have pretty good special attack and good enough speed.
As I'll say, PsyJ probably be good on the ranges for Lance, but it might be.
I don't think PsyJ will have. Won't guarantee the range for Dragonite, but
no.
If they do, if he does safe strats, then it will be fine.
Yeah.
But yes. Okay, dude, two controller. Okay. This is not going for one CGO. Which is fair.
Yeah. No one wants to get hit by the crit earthquake.
Yeah, bad check time. Okay, Rapidash died. Didn't live on Power of Love. Nice.
Yes, Bad's check is where I try not to talk to my Rapidash.
If I talk to anywhere, it's when I try to surf.
Oh yeah, that too. Get that one extra click past the badge checks and Find out Rapidash is just doing okay.
Yeah, so here, like, see the grass behind that swimmer badge check? So I, like, angled it up to, like, get into the water, like, as far away from possible from this badge check person to hit a Pokemon, and then they would just turn me to the badge check person and not hit the Pokemon. But that would also make the speedrun bad, because it would skip Koga.
Oh, it would, yeah.
And catching 50 Pokemon is personally why I think this run is interesting.
Yes. The 50 catch on this is just... it makes it very different from most other Pokemon runs.
Hey, does Dynam want to make this interesting and one-C Naomi?
Yes, do the one-C...
There's no need to 1C Naomi, but to bring some entertainment to the run.
Make up for the Squirtle miss, for the not Squirtle catch.
Oh yeah, so Dynam had the worst, one of the worst Route 10s.
That was bad.
Eventually caught like a good amount of things, but it took forever for them all to spawn. Had to repel twice. That was punishment for not catching the star, or the Squirtle. Squirtle.
To be fair, the Squirtle was on the farthest end of the grass. But...
yeah. Hey, when I... You remember, I disclaimed it and said it was smart because it was so far away, but...
oh yeah, you did.
But
still, should have gone for it.
Yeah, exactly. Would have better Route 10 luck. It was all Route 10 and it.
Yes.
Okay, so if that trainer's looking down, you can still go past him because he can't see that far.
Yeah.
I learned that just recently, so.
Same.
We'll die to Hydro Pump this Hypno, because that's a safe thing to try, at least. It won't kill.
Special attack's pretty good. He might hit it.
I don't know the ranges off the top. I don't know any of these ranges off the top of my head, but... yeah, what... you should... go on.
What was the star at? Do you remember?
We'll find out soon.
Yeah.
At, Caroline.
It's 100% at 152.
Oh, dodge the Hydro Pump. No! Didn't get put to sleep. I forgot. Hopefully none of the runners hit Alexa, but that could also actually make Dynam not win. If Dynam hits Alexa. I totally forgot that's an option.
That being said, you can save up your psychics in a couple ways. I think his special attack's good enough that he could... not have to heal to renew his PP.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I mean, they just won't hit Alexa anyway. So.
Yeah, there's that. But if they do...
just boulder pushing. Yeah, seeing 1C Naomi in a race is kind of... shocking.
Insanity.
Because it's not safe, and it's just like... they're like very minor instances that you would do it. So we will see. In these later rounds, the people trailing might be forced to 1C Naomi just to save that time if they're like that far behind, but like safe strats will like let the other person win, so they need to okay, Dynam, easy.
Nice.
I feel like when I try that, like for me personally, it's more that's a feel thing, so like whatever works for you, do it, because then you'll more likely to hit it. The feel for me personally, if I do that, I feel less safe.
Oh, when you try to ride the wall up?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's when I hit her more often, is if I don't just go for the corner. Up at the top.
Like if I like when I do a clean and like don't clip it, like I feel good. But if I like clip the wall, I feel like more nervous.
Yeah.
Add to Awakening Caroline. Just hit the pump. Easy.
There you go.
I'll step and miss. Okay, so level up here. So we got 139.
Nice.
Dynam plus 4? I think it's a range from Boralion. Is it? No, it should. I still don't know.
139. Yeah, 139, he should be able to plus 4.
Okay.
That's right on the cutoff. It will be a range for Scald on Jinx, but...
13 and 16, yeah, I see. That's fine. I mean, you're hydro pumping Jinx anyway, right? 13/16 is better than 80%, is it? I think it's barely better, right? Because 12/16 is 75, so like 13/16 is like 82 or something.
Yeah, something like that.
Sweet Caroline. I forget the rest of the lyrics. So good, so good, so good.
Good times never felt so good.
Yeah.
Lyrical genius.
Oh, can't push from this direction. Can't push from this direction, Headbob. Come on.
I hate pushing these stones.
Hey, my family has Boston origins. Okay, Headbob, let's go. Easy.
Nice.
A power whip to Headbob.
How will Caroline go?
Just don't get super mega screwed.
Yeah.
Avoided the sleep.
Oh.
Okay. Hit the pump.
Oh no! Hit the sleep. In the sleep.
Great ice beam. Nice. Oh. Okay. So for people that don't know, if you get frozen by the ice beam, just scald instead because it heals the freeze. So scald gets rid of freeze. 141. At 51. So that's a 14/16 for plus 4, or for plus 4 Scald for Gorbai. Is the Lorelei song like something when I think of Lorelei, my head spins round and round. Something stings like a... I don't remember. Is that the song?
I don't know that one.
Okay, we're just pushing boulders on Headbob screen.
And... boulders inside you.
I have no idea what pace this is, even though we're at lead 4.
Fast. It is a fast pace.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I imagine Dynam will just do the plus 4 setup.
2C Bruno potential! We have 2C Bruno potential! Who's ready for 2C Bruno?
Let's do it.
Hey, come on, PsyJ. Please don't.
Don't hit it.
Easy.
Nice.
Okay, can we get the Colby skip? Yes, everyone taking that talk so safe now.
Yeah. No longer talking between them, only talking to Caroline.
Imagine that happened during a race, and the commentators were just like, what happened?
Also, that fight is not good. Nice. Easy.
I expect PsyJ to do just safety four.
Yeah.
We will see what happens. 129.
Oof.
Okay, I don't think we're gonna see faint, because I'm pretty sure Dynam's healed.
Wait, PsyJ special is 129?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's gonna be tight on the Dragonite.
I mean, we'll hit 54, so we'll gain one extra level compared to usual.
Yeah.
We'll see if Dynam heals, but I think Earthquake could kill, depending on the defense. So, we might just not even see, can't push it from this direction. Not healing, okay. Come on, it's fate time! Don't stealth rock. Please, Earthquake.
Earthquake into faint.
Earthquake into faint, come on!
Does Dynam still have Rapidash in the party?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So it's more likely to stealth rock.
Earthquake, please! Earthquake, please! Please, 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 please! No! It's Onyx Hate's fun! Boo! 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 Okay, well, Dynam's still 2C anyway, for the memes. Dynam has time.
He does. He's got enough time to...
Headbob is now frozen?
No!
Are we good? I can't...
That's what happens when you get to Lorelei.
I don't know what happened, but...
He's hitting a little bit of lag getting into that Indigo Plateau cutscene. There we go.
The frames are dropping.
Yeah.
Okay. Did they hear you? I don't know if everyone heard Jordan, but... Okay. Jordan is trying to do stuff, but... Headbob internet might be, breaking, so. Okay. Here's the heal.
Heal and...
Feel like this is 305 pace for Dynam?
Yeah, it should be pretty close around there. Once he strats for Agatha.
I wonder if Headbob will go for unsafe strats to try and beat T-Pack. He might not be close enough though where he's just safe and secure like upper bracket placements. Oh! Defense thing, but
Power of love.
Wait, that was crunch turn one.
Yeah.
Turn two.
Yeah, it was turn two, because he powered love through the para.
Yeah, that's turn two. So, nice. Should have skipped full restore. Come on now. I kind of just expect safe fights from everybody, so these places should hold. I'm not expecting... not expecting anyone to do risky stuff.
Yeah, I think at this point, just for the tournament, it's best to just hold on the course for your time.
This is why we shouldn't have mage safe strats, so Champ and Lance are, like, tense. They're like, oh, is someone gonna get crit?
Yeah.
But I think they're all kind of... I think Dynam's not had enough where safe strats don't matter. And same with Headbob.
Yeah.
I could be wrong, though, because it's fairly new, so I don't know the time differences.
I think they're probably spaced off, based enough that they'll be safe to keep with it.
Yeah, Headbob, 258 starring Agatha, would have to beat my 308.50 to be upper, which could definitely done 2C, but Wave and Trivor tomorrow, so Headbob may want to do 1C for... to get like a little better time for the Trivor and Wave race tomorrow, because I'm fairly confident that they will both of them will also beat the 308.50 that I have, so Headbob might want to try for the best time possible in 1C against
champ. Yeah, and chat's saying that he only has one Pokeball, so he may be going for the 1C on Lance.
Oh, definitely.
Para Odo.
We can't tell.
No!
I can't tell what happened. Well, we are tense in not knowing what happened.
Oh, here comes.
Oh. When did Headbob deposit, by the way? I didn't notice that.
I think he deposited for Lorelei or Bruno, one of two.
What's going on? What's going on? Yeah, so Dynam with the safe has the champ range. 146 I saw, so 146. That is a 10 and 16 plus 2 Thunderbolt range and a 14-16 Jolteon range. Saying this is a race, I would not go for that. If it wasn't a race, I would totally go for that.
Yeah, just keeping it safe. Add that extra special attack, it'll be great.
It'll be 2C, too. Like.
Yeah. They'll be fine.
Yeah. So it'll be like a... I wonder if this will be close to being pot one. It might be.
Yeah, it's gonna be real close.
But like I said, is pot one really a reward?
Yeah, when you get the world record holder in pot two, that's...
I mean, at least for me, I don't know who your top people are, but my top two are like Etchy and Amber, and they're both in separate pots. So, yeah. Does it really matter what pot you're in?
No, you have a chance of hitting either one of them.
I mean, like we said before, all the upper people could take each other out, so it's not like anyone's really like a easy thing. Unless somehow I make it, but I won't make it, so.
It'll say, the only safe one is to not finish in the first bracket.
That's right, that's why I'm going to lower specifically for that.
Yeah, there you go. Wreak havoc in the lower bracket, come back, and you'll be great.
I don't think Dynam can miss in a move, so maybe he's Dynam. Headbob's kind of back.
Yep.
Lance was fine.
Yeah. The champion did target Starmie, so Rapidash is still alive for Dynam.
Oh, yeah, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Well, I wonder if it matters. Well, like, yeah, we'll see what the... Kane the level, slow.
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, the Headbob stream looks good. It was go. Oh! Okay.
It's the Dragonite? Great.
So Headbob's, I think, like 306, 307? Something like that?
Sure. Would put him in the second.
Not saving. Oh, okay. I'm like, that's a long black screen, and then we're facing champ. Yes. So let's come on, let's go, head bob.
Yes.
Let's bob some heads.
It'll be interesting to see PsyJ's range on this Dragonite.
Okay, GG's Dynam, I think.
Yes.
Dynam might be upper. I think Dynam might be etiquette's time by like a few seconds. Okay. Please. Okay, I think Headbob's good. Cause I think that that's plus one, right? So Headbob should be fine.
We'll heal out of Crook Attack range. Yeah, it should be solid.
Yep. Okay, will Dynam be Ergo? No, time's just not gonna be Ergo. Will be etiquette's time.
Yeah.
GG Dynam. 305.10 is what this timer says.
Hello.
GG. Hello. Wait, pump? Wait, what happened? Topped it out! Wait! What? Wait, what happened?
Oh no.
Headbob, forget the sub.
Oh my god! I'm just watching this right now. Holy crap!
Wait.
Oh no.
Quick attack. It's got a quick attack, right? It's got a quick attack.
Yeah, you have to heal out QA.
Yeah. Okay, hit this pump. Please hit this pump. No!
No!
Oh, oh wait, no. It's still alive! It's still alive! Oh, come on!
No!
Oh. Come on!
What did Headbob do to get into this position?
I don't know. I was looking at your timer. Oh, he has...
He has one more pump!
One pump!
Okay, he hit it. Okay. We're good.
Easy.
Oh. Not even
worried.
Oh, wait,
it came out second?
Oh.
Wait. Wait, what happened? Wait, why did it come out second? Wait, it switched. Pidgeot's not dead.
Oh, did he go for, like, plus two T-Bolt or something?
I thought it was plus four T-Bolt, but I guess it was plus two.
I didn't know Pidgeot could switch.
Oh, god.
Pidgeot switched. Oh, oh dear. Barely, so it must have been plus two Thunderbolt that Headbob went for.
Yeah.
Holy crap.
Oh, it just has a full. Okay. Crack just went on. Everything is fine.
Still upper bracket for now. We'll see what tomorrow holds. But.
Anyway, hello!
Congrats on... right now you are in upper pot one.
Yes. Barely.
Yeah, I just want to say boo, not catching the Squirtle, but it was also the smart choice. So.
Yeah, I find new and exciting ways to disappoint everybody. First, bring out 2C on Bruno, ignoring the Squirtle on Route 25.
If it was closer, would you have caught it?
Yeah, I would have gone for it, just being, like, the possibility of two evolutions. If it was on the right side, I would have gone for it, but the distance was just too far for me.
Yeah,
no, when I saw how far it was, I'm like...
I just also kind of panicked and was just like, alright, just stick to what you know, and I don't know Squirtle very well.
That's
so...
legit.
Yeah, that's fair. So... Talk about your route 10 was awful.
It was the worst route 10 I have ever seen in my entire life.
Like at least even though it took so long, at least you got Pokemon at the end, so your catch count was like fine. At, but like
at the cost of both of my repels.
Yeah.
Eventually. But yeah, Moon, well, just like getting bodied by encounters was like nothing new to me, but Route 10 just kind of threw me for a loop this time around. She used the Headbob.
Oh yeah, you saw the Clefairy, right? And then you like paused and then you...
No, okay, so I have a reason for... It's not a... Okay, so my thinking when I like doubled back on the optional was that like, oh, the spinner usually spins by the time I get to this point, like, I haven't seen her spin yet, and I was just staring so closely at her that I wasn't paying attention to where my character was relative to her.
Oh, okay.
So that's why I ended up doubling back on her.
Yeah, because it looked to us like the Clefairy just spawned, and we saw you like go back at like that time when it spawned, and then...
I'll be honest, didn't even see the Clefairy.
Okay, Headbob.
I have little to no words.
So did you plus two? You plus two the Pidgeot, right? And it lit. That's what happened.
Yeah. So I thought it would just heal. That's what I thought would happen. So okay. I was like, okay, I'll just take the 12 and 16 instead of like the chance to get crit and just lose the run. Because I needed a plus four. But if I had known that it would do that every time, I also would have been fine because I could have just set up on the turn it switched out.
But yeah,
because I had no idea it was going to do that, so I was like, what the fuck?
Because I was just finishing, so I was looking at Dime's time to see if he would beat etiquette, and then all of a sudden I see Jolteon and you pumping it, and I'm like, what happened?
You were in quite the situation, but I'm glad you pulled through.
GG, wow. PsyJ. PsyJ,
I also had no idea it's quick attack, by the way. I had no idea, so I just kind of guessed.
Yeah, nice guessing.
GG's guess.
Congrats, PsyJ. You are... I think you clinched... Yeah, you clinched lower pot one.
Oh, sick.
Your reward is potentially facing Aspect, because he's now in two.
Oh, that's exciting.
I mean, he would have done it anyway, whether you were in pot one or pot two.
Yeah, but... Oh, wow, that was a run. I have so many questions about my catch route.
Oh, thanks for catching the Clefable and the Chansey.
You're welcome, yes. You're welcome. I saw the Clefable, and I put in chat while I was catching the Paris. I guess I'll do it for the fans.
I saw that, yeah.
I'm anything up for anything.
Your Eevee was tragic because it barely missed killing Arbok both times.
Oh my god, I was so sad.
Oh no.
And then I caught like the worst Starmie in existence.
Yeah, well the speed was good.
Speed was amazing. I was really tempted to like look up the speeds on Agatha's Pokemon. I'm like, I wonder if I'm close enough.
It was, I think we said 155?
Yeah, 155.
Yeah, I was 157 on Lance, so I probably would have tied or been slower.
Awesome. Yeah.
I saw the special attack on the Starmie, and I'm like, all right, this is a 3+2 Starmie, so I gotta go find another candy. Starmie sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, Diamond Headbob had way better special attacks.
That's fine.
So I've only run Pika for like the last like couple of days or so. For Eevee, I know how to deal with like pretty much any Eevee you can get, because I've been running it long enough, and I'm running like every different type of Eevee.
Yeah. But
that was the first time I've ever run minus attack on Pikachu. So I'm just kind of like improvising the entire time.
Oh no, you had minus attack?
It was basically when you got the chance, he was fine, because you loved
The
Clefable and the Chansey. Yeah, that's what
That Clefable, I'm kind of glad I didn't get it first ball. Like, I got motion controlled.
Yeah,
2,700 experience.
It was either really big or really small. I forget what color it was, but yeah, it would have been 24. Okay, so it's really small.
Yeah, and I was like, I think it was Iron who posted the chat was like, "Wow, we're leaving Moon at 18." And I'm like, "I'm gonna have Weepin' Bell, my rival 3."
Yeah.
Okay, wait. I have a question. Is anyone who knows? If you miss the +2 Thunderbolt range, does that happen every time?
I think so. Yes.
Okay. For next time.
Couldn't tell you. Never plus two Thunderbolts of the Pidgeot in my life.
I've been able to go for it once in my life, and it feels really good when you
Okay, apparently it. It can heal. It heals just
okay,
when
so then, okay, so if it's... I mean, I think if it always switches, then it's, like, fine to go for, right? Because then you just set up your last X spec, and, like, when on the turn it switches. But if it can do either, then it's fucked.
Wait, it switched?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's switched.
Yeah. So you almost got second.
I didn't know a rival could do this. I'm learning.
Yeah.
Something.
So, Headbob plus two Thunderbolt and missed the range of the switch, and all of a sudden Jolteon's out, and Headbob missed two pumps, had to heal like twice, hit the third pump.
And lived first Thunder on Power of Love.
Yeah, lived on Power of Love.
God.
And then lived on three.
Lived and then on the second three. Time I lived on like yeah, I just tanked it normally.
Oh my god. Did you one seat to try and get a better pot three times?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's what we thought.
And then here we are anyways, just that orb.
Yeah.
Did you end up saving before Champ or Lance Headbob?
No, nope.
Oh wow.
No, I didn't save either.
I figured it was like such a slim chance for me to like advance to uppers anyways, like DNFing is effectively the same thing as like getting a 310, right? So like
yeah.
I do hope chat enjoyed that race. All three of us were pretty close to each other the whole time.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think Dynam pulled ahead like super, super late, but
well, Dynam was ahead early, and then Route 10 brought it back, but then Dynam just kept slowly gaining time throughout the rest of the run.
Yeah, that Route 10 was Route 10. I had to rappel twice.
Yeah.
I burned my rappel in I think Rock Tunnel where like there was just a bunch of stuff in my way and I'm like, no, I'm not dealing with this.
Oh yeah, so I saw that. At that point you only need a Cubone left, so I was like
my brain just immediately put the lure back on and I'm like, why did I do that? That was stupid. Okay. I don't need anything here.
Okay, yeah.
I was like, I can leave without Cubone. What, I have like 36 leaving tunnel or something?
Yeah,
something like
insane.
That, yeah.
Insane.
I just caught everything.
So Dynam had the best archer fight with four turns, and then PsyJ, yours and Headbob's were like both not good.
Oh, mine was awful.
It was totally worse. I'm pretty sure it was worse.
After the archer fight, I was like, you know what? All my homies hate Archer 2. Like, what a terrible fight.
All my homies hate Archer 2.
All my homies hate this guy.
Yeah, Dynam got like one Thunderbolt and then Raticate dead turn 2.
I feel like I lost a year in Koga's gym too.
Well, I think you mean compared to me or your PB or both?
Compared to PB. Like, I didn't have my PB time up, but I'm like, this is a really, really good time for me. Like, where am I? Like, I was trying to figure out how close I was to PB, and then, like, after Koga, I was like, alright, never mind, we're fine. This is out of the realm of possibility.
Because I was going to say, if you meant me, I don't think anyone besides Amber noticed, but I got Reflect turn 1, and I had level 48 because I got a supersized Grimer and Mansion, so I had 48 for Mime, and I got Reflect turn 1, so I just pumped and killed the Mime.
Oh, nice.
Saved, like, two turns.
Oh, that is sick.
That's actually so great.
Yeah, so like, yeah, the first time I've ever done that.
Yeah, congrats to all three of you.
Yeah, GG.
Thanks,
that 310, that's the best time I've had since coming back, so. Excited to grind this game more now.
Yeah, we'll see if, Headbob, if you could stay in upper, and if Dynam goes to, Pot 1 or Pot 2, stays in Pot 1 and goes to 2. Would you rather face Amber or Etchy next round?
I have no comment on this. Honestly, I'll leave it up to the next race to figure it out. Both pots are equally scary to be in and to face against, so...
I think all three pots are, like, equally scary at this point.
Yeah, for sure.
I gotta see who's in lower Pot 3, so... Yeah, see you. Or lower pot one, I think, is where I'll end up.
You definitely will, because there's only one race left.
Oh, there is.
There's only one upper, and you beat Iron by like 13 seconds. So,
oh my god.
Only Iron can get bopped to pot two. All
right. Damn.
Yeah.
Wild.
You are where you are.
Cool. Yeah, I didn't get a chance to pay attention to a lot of the races this week. I've been traveling the last 2 weeks. So, additionally, shout out to both Dynam and Headbob for being very accommodating. My schedule the last 2 weeks has been absolutely bonkers. Been to the two biggest esports tournaments in like the U.S. doing production work. So,
yeah,
wasn't an issue.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we got tomorrow's race as the final race of the round. It will be at 12 Eastern with Wave Warrior versus Trevaria versus Quo. It'll be fun. You guys, what is everyone's expectations for this race?
It's gonna be a little hype match.
I was looking at the pickems for this race, and I saw that like 12 people pick Wave and 9 people pick Triv. So I think it's probably the most divisive race of the round. So it's gonna be very interesting, I think.
Yeah, this one's really, really good.
Yeah, because it's the lowest seed from this round's pot one versus the highest from pot two.
Yeah, seed six and seven. It was then we'll see if Quo's been practicing, maybe Quo can knock off one of the two.
Dang.
Not sure how much Quo's been grinding this for the tournament, but always a possibility. But yeah. Thanks to Jordan.
Phoenix saying a solid nearly 12 hours of let's go today.
We had banging races today. We had started the day right with JT versus Sheep versus Drywall. I know JT and Sheep are both moving to the next round. And then we got Furious versus Phoenix, which is also good. And then we had this race, which was great. So, yeah. Anything else, people?
No.
No, I mean, that was fun. That was really good.
Yeah, GG's to everyone. Shout out to Jordan on tech for saving our streams.
Incredible as always.
Yep.
Yes.
And thanks to both of y'all for commentating as well, Joker and Simlick. Looking forward to watching this back as well.
Same.
But yeah, so we have the race tomorrow, and then I think like almost right after the race ends, we will do draws for round three. So yes. Very exciting. Have a good night or day, everybody.
Awesome. Thanks everybody. Thanks for watching.
See y'all.
See you.